What's up, you negative Nellies? You lumpy liver lickers? Terrence Popp here, Redonkulous.com, and I have my co-host with me.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Toxic male.
Toxic.
Otherwise known as Blake.
The impersonator.
The impersonator. Yes, I do impersonations for you. See, it looks like you have up there a full menagerie.
I have.
Is it that kind of day?
I'm going to be honest. I need the full menagerie, and I probably might have to double it up today.
Yeah, I'm gonna remove my spoon so I don't sound like Styx Hexenhammer over here.
He puts out some good stuff.
Oh, we are big fans of the Clankdom over here, but I don't really want to recreate it.
Yeah.
What is it? Can I check the connection device? What the hell was that?
Well,
all of a sudden, I have an error on my camera. Son of a bitch!
On your camera or mine?
On my camera. Your camera's fine. Nobody wants to look at my ugly mug anyway. I shall return.
All right.
Talk about something.
I'm gonna give you a little story from my past. So I meet this girl. She's pretty hot. So I give her the... And it went pretty well. So, you know, next time I went over there, I put it in her mouth, and I got one of these. And a couple weeks later, I'm over there. It's around midnight. She decides to get, like, really drunk. Like, anally drunk. You know, I'm not into that, but, you know, with enough alcohol, it's an on-request thing. And then afterwards, you get one of these. So I had to... And I ran through the door.
You ran through the door.
Yeah, the screen door. And everyone was... And I never went back.
All aboard the Cry-tanic.
Oh, this thing. I got to thank the fan that sent me this. This is comedy gold right
here. It is, man. It's comedy gold in a box. We know all about that.
Yeah, allegedly.
Allegedly. I've only ever had one anally drunk experience. So, but we
yeah, I'm
drunk.
Not really big into that, man. I've turned it down quite a few times.
I'm
just not into that. If I liked it, I'd be gay, and I'm not gay.
Yeah, you want to...
Plus, you can get some, like, serious, nasty, like, infections from that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you literally got somebody's poo juices and digested food trying to creep its way on up your pee hole.
Yep. It's all slickery down there. Ugh.
Yeah. Those holes are only a couple of millimeters apart, man. Talk about a flaw in the design.
Yeah, I had one.
Unless that's all part of the gag.
I had one of my NCOs that was he owned a dojo, and one night after class, he's locking up and he's throwing down with one of the students. Has her on all fours.
Oh boy!
You know, she had like three kids, and she was, you know, a little older, and that 2 millimeters, boom! she passed out. She got up, called him an animal, left, and never came back.
You animal! How dare you!
And he's trying to explain. He's like, I didn't mean it. It just happened. I, you know, hey,
what are you going to do?
He told me that story. I just laughed. That's some good shit right there.
Well, that really does. That's a perfect segue into our first story of the day, which not even really a story. It's just freaking hilarious. This came in an email that we got from Louder with Crowder. If you guys don't subscribe to the newsletter, it's really good stuff. I'm going to click over here so you guys can see it. Woman accuses two bros of harassing her, quickly feels stupid once they point to her car. You guys are going to love this.
Have a...
Leave me alone. Why do you keep following me? It's honestly so creepy, and I'm going to call the cops.
Ma'am,
okay?
No.
Because you guys aren't leaving me alone, and that's my way
and you're not letting
the
them
world
talk
by themselves, because of guys like you.
What?
Okay? So stop following
you,
me.
Wait
have,
for it.
Oh, like, just, I don't know if you have like a like gas problem. You have a thing hanging out of your car.
What are you talking about?
There's literally a gas hose hanging out of your car. No one's being creeped. Oh. No, thank you. I guess.
Notice how, she doesn't say thank you.
The thank you. That's, she's what?
Oh, she just throws it in her car and leaves.
Thank you to get all of it.
Oh, man.
That's what you have to say when you're done with her and the poop wipes off on her booty hole.
All right,
make sure you get all of it.
First of all the gas stations have cameras now.
Yeah.
So they actually have her on camera putting gas in her car, forgetting to take it out, driving off with it, and she's on the hook for repair. She's going to have to pay the cost of repairing that gas thing.
Oh, yeah.
And having it reinspected so it could be used.
And that's
not cheap.
No, and that's not the first time that I've seen a video like that.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my God. I hope I never do something stupid like that.
It cracks me up. And you notice that she was so quick on the draw. She already had the phone in her hand, mm-hmm. getting ready to either film them to expose them as creeps in some pro-women thread on Reddit or call the cops. So my guess is that phone was probably in her hand at the gas station. You know, she's got to pull down the sports bra and sneak a little nipple for the OnlyFans, and then she gets distracted because it's not the first time she's had something big, black, and long hanging out of her tank, and then she just fucking drives off. The end.
Yeah, and you know the thing is they have like a shut off thing in the gas pump.
Yeah.
So there probably wasn't a lot of gas spilled, but if it was an older pump that doesn't have that, the attendant has to come out and like turn a key on the pump to turn it off.
Ooh.
Yeah, that could be all kinds of bad.
That could have been very bad.
Because you have one knucklehead flick a cigarette out.
Ooh, yeah.
And guess what?
Be like that scene in Airplane. Or was it Airplane 2? I'm not sure which one.
It's a towering inferno, except, you know, it's on the ground and people are parked around it. It's stupid.
It really is. But that was a much-needed laugh that I needed today.
Yeah.
That's for sure. Because we have a lot of really, really bad news for people tonight. I don't know why you didn't wear the red shirt, to be totally honest.
Thus the menagerie.
Thus the menagerie. But what else you got up there? I think you got a couple of books up there.
Oh, yeah. I got the ones from Aaron Clary. Surviving.
No, that's not Aaron Clary. That's Dr. B-Real.
Dr. B-Real?
Dr. B-Real. He sounds like a rapper, but he's not. He's an author.
Surviving Fourth Wave Feminism.
There are at least two volumes.
There's two volumes.
This, possibly three. I'm not sure. He might be on to three by now.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, I should probably write something similar, but I would make it as long because I'm an idiot. But he really dissects and dives into it in detail. And I think these are worth the purchase, to be honest with you.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. We have links to Dr. B. Real's book in the description. He's been a longtime sponsor of the show. If you guys have not bought one of his books yet, check him out.
Yeah.
You will not regret it. Or if you do regret it, at the very least, you'll be more informed.
Yeah, he literally talks about how the feminism is basically recruiting the youth of today to attack the West from within.
Gee, that doesn't sound familiar, and it doesn't. I mean, yeah. Like, haven't there been like some stunning and brave protests from people saying that the U.S. needs to be like torn down and rebuilt from the ground up, and
the
system doesn't work anymore, so we got to burn it down.
Same thing happened in China.
Stunning and brave.
The Red Revolution or whatever?
Yeah.
From 1964 to 75, and then it was starting to get ramped up again in 1982 with the Tiananmen Square.
They
surrounded those people and wiped them out.
You're going to fucking
They didn't
jail.
Want to do that twice. Because the first time cost 30 million dead.
Jail.
30 million.
Wow.
If that happens here, that's 10% of our population goes up in smoke.
Yeah, that's not good.
No.
No, that would not be a good day. Somebody in the comments said something about Aaron Clary Demand. Well, set your watches or calendars or whatever it is you got. Aaron Clary will be on Grunt Speak Live with us Tuesday, March 16th, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. Winning.
Boom.
Boom.
Outstanding.
Yep, and we get to go and see him in person at the end of March, too. We're doing a little promo shoot out in Las Vegas. It's going to be a weekend of power drinking and good times.
I want to do power eating because they have good food down there.
Oh, the buffets. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, if you're a gambler, I'm not particularly a gambler, but if you're a gamble, that's where you get your money back, is at those damn buffets.
Those buffets are good.
Yeah.
I'd tear that shit up.
Just pile up a whole bunch of eggs and whatever else, you know, like the breakfast buffet, lunch buffet.
I go right to the lobster and the crab, and then I'll get a nice steak, And I'll go back for more lobster, crab, and shrimp, and get on the steak. Then maybe for dessert, I'll have a bunch of mussels and oysters.
You know, I never noticed this.
It's meat candy, man.
Meat candy, yeah. I never noticed this before. Maybe you guys can tell me if I'm wrong. I'm going to say this in such a way where we won't get banned on YouTube.
Okay.
Hopefully. But when you're at a buffet, I never noticed that stunning and brave people of color of the Jamal persuasion really love crab legs.
What?
Yes. I didn't know this.
Oh, they go crazy over
there. I was at this place. It was like called Mongolian Buffet, which they really should just call it food poisoning on delay. It's just, that's
yeah,
just my
yeah.
personal opinion.
That's how you get a butt worm.
But I didn't know this. Like, there was always this tray whenever I'd walk around. It would always be empty. And then I just happened to be going over to get something, and then all of a sudden they bring out the crab legs. And it was like that scene in Ratatouille where the guy walks into the fridge and flicks the light on, and all the rats are just like...
yeah.
And then just disappear with the crab legs, run back to their tables.
Yeah, I've seen that happen.
Everybody's got their buffet stereotypes. That's just one that I happened to notice that day. I thought it was pretty funny.
Mm-hmm. I used to like to go to the Golden Corral, too.
Yeah. I miss Golden Corral.
It's not up here in Michigan anymore, is it?
There is one in Shelby Township.
Really?
Yeah, it's on Hall Road. If they're open.
If they're open.
If yeah. they're open.
Because, you know, that's just a big COVID transmission, you know, festering pot of doom.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Bullshit.
Yeah, unless you're going to Walmart, Costco, or some other gigantic corporate establishment to get your stuff, it's a biological bomb and you want to kill grandma, they need to shut it down.
That's absolute bullshit, man.
Yes, it is. You know what else is absolute bullshit, though?
What?
Well, like I said, it's been a day for interesting kinds of news. But it does involve one of your favorite things in the world. Can you guess what it is?
Guns?
Yes. You guys are going to love this. Well, love it and hate it.
All right.
This is on Law Enforcement Today. Family of shooter who opened fire in a gun store now claiming he was murdered by those who stopped him.
All right. Okay. No, first of all, this is not the first time we've heard something like this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Like, there was a couple instances over the past 3 years where somebody breaks into somebody's house and they get mowed down with the AR-15 and they say, well, it wasn't fair. Like, motherfucker, it's not supposed to be fair.
Like, you break into somebody's house while they're home, you intend to do them harm.
That's right. I mean, that is the first assumption. They're not there to, like, you know, tickle your feet and... And maybe, you know, get you some warm milk and tuck you in. They're there to bash your brains out and take your shit.
Yeah.
You know? And, hey, if somebody breaks into my house, I might have to, like, pull out the 12-gauge.
That would be unfortunate.
And defend my house.
Well, son of a bitch. Is this working?
I don't know. Is it?
MGTOW TV is not streaming. I just saw somebody come up in the comments. I'm not sure what's going on. I think we did have an issue with a change in IP address. Because I had to redo a whole bunch of stuff that I know was already done. So that may be the issue here. Yeah, which means that DLive is probably not streaming as well. If that's true, you guys out there, if you wanted to watch it on those two alt-tech platforms, I apologize. Not really sure what the issue is with that.
Well, I mean, it is what it is. We don't have a fixed IP address.
Yeah, so. Yeah. This is also offline. Shoot.
And they probably change it every 1 to 2 weeks.
Yeah, and what really sucks is that once you actually begin the stream, you can't go in and fix it.
Yeah.
You can terminate a stream in the middle on each individual channel, but you can't actually start one up. So my apologies to everybody out there. Sorry about that. I thought we were doing so good.
Oh, well.
Son of a bitch!
What are you going to do?
It'll be fixed next week, I promise.
We got it up
guys.
On Facebook.
Yeah, it's actually on Facebook.
For what that's worth.
Yeah, they're going to find your new account and rip it a Charlie Brown ghost ass and throw it out with the fucking chicken bones.
Like go home, the last check time. My Facebook, and it's just deleted. And the funny thing is, I can find my old Facebook pages if I search for them.
Yeah.
But when I go there, it says, you know, unavailable.
Unavailable.
But they're showing up in all kinds of searches.
That's weird.
France, Japan, Germany, Poland. I mean, it's insane.
Yeah. It is kind of weird. I don't know why. But I want to dive back into the story a little bit.
All right, all right, yeah.
As I once again, sorry about the technical difficulties. I will make sure that that is fixed for the next one. What really cracks me up about this one is, of course, they've got, you know, the family and friends are making comments here. But just for context, in this shooting, which was apparently, it looks like it was a Jefferson gun outlet in Louisiana, three people killed, two injured. All right. And the basic story is this dude, he stormed into this place at 2:50 p.m. on the day of the incident. A man later identified as 27-year-old Joshua Jamal Williams murdered a store employee and a customer before he was fatally shot by no less than seven unarmed customers and store employees.
Well, if they shot him, they weren't unarmed.
Well, seven armed. I'm sorry. Right. I probably misspoke. But seven armed customers and store employees.
Bummer.
I think that's called instant karma. Just add bullets.
Yeah, I mean, you got to be a special kind of stupid to think you're going to get away with that in a gun store.
A little bit. Apparently, he came in with a pistol with an extended clip into the range, and when the staff told him to unload his weapon, he just started firing at people.
Really?
Yes, but of course, his widow, you know, has to get in there and try to pull at the heartstrings. He was amazing. Words cannot describe the person that he was. He was so genuine, so real, and so true. He was my soulmate.
All right. From what I had read, he was pretty much unprovoked.
Yeah.
All right, but I'm going to be honest. Like, if you own a piece of property and the local principality decides there's something wrong and they come out with bulldozers and start bulldozing your house, and yeah. The guy who owned the property decides to go, you know, King Cobra and start smoking people.
King Cobra.
I'm serious. I'd be like, and then if they try to turn him into a villain in the media, I'd be like, hey, you know, you go to his house, you start bulldozing shit, you know, you get what you get. It's kind of like the guy who built a tank.
Oh, I have been corrected. Yeah, I've just been kind of skimming through this here. The grieving widow was talking about the guy who was actually murdered. My bad.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that. So. But yeah, well, okay, down here we actually have the Williams family. He was murdered. I guess they know better than to talk any more than that, but they did spell murdered all caps. There's an all caps rage here.
Yeah, I do that all the time.
I got nothing.
But you remember back in, it was like maybe a decade ago, a guy like built a tank out of a bulldozer, they call it the killdozer.
And he just
like smashed half a town down.
They did a whole documentary about that.
Yeah.
I think it's called Tread or something like that.
I don't know. And then they make him to be this like terrible person. And I'm like, what about what you did to him to motivate him to build a fucking tank and decide to like just start taking out the town?
Yeah, see, that's a whole other level.
Yeah,
of stuff. And yes, I want to make sure it is available on Netflix, apparently, this documentary. Yeah. It is called Tread, and it is about the man who welded himself inside of the killdozer and destroyed half of a town called Granby.
Yeah, if he was smart.
Here's a picture of it right here. You can see this thing.
Uh-huh. If he was smart, he would have had some gun ports in there, some weapons in there, and maybe a flamethrower.
A flamethrower.
Oh, no, nothing says I hate your guts like a flamethrower.
What particularly about a flamethrower says I hate your guts? More so than bullets or anything else.
Well, first of all, like if it's in the front of the tank, you go through the side of a building, you knock down the wall, and then you just flood the inside with fire.
Oh, yeah.
And like people like are on fire, it'd be terrible. I mean, setting people on fire is a whole new level of hatred. Remember in Private Ryan when the guys were falling out of the pillbox?
Oh, yeah.
And like,
yeah.
Don't shoot them, let them burn.
That's a
whole other level, man.
That is a whole other level. I will agree with that. Especially because, you know, if something that fucking just deadly is coming at you, like, oh, okay, here comes the killdozer. It's got a giant fucking, like, plow shovel on the front, and there's guns and shit sticking out the side. You're like, well, okay, well, at least it'll be quick. And then all of a sudden it stops once it knocks down the wall, and you just stare at it, and all of a sudden it kicks the flamethrower on, and you just hear the guide inside going, you're like, oh, shit!
Yeah.
It's like just the tip with...
and they were, like, shooting at him, and, you know, this man, it was crazy. But I don't know if that documentary goes into detail of what they were doing to that guy. They're like slowly like taking his business away, and they just kept fucking with them and fucking with them until he said, you know, fuck it. I'm going to weld myself into this bulldozer and run some people over.
See, that's the guy who gets screwed by the system who doesn't learn to laugh. It's like you said, you know, you have to keep your cool, right? Or what is it? Chill.
Yeah.
The cool head. What is the acronym?
Well, you keep a cool mind.
Cool head. Yep.
Higher level thinking.
Yes.
Intelligence. Laughter.
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, what is the other? There was another L in there. Like
basically
latitude or whatever it was. Yeah, I forget what it was. Yeah,
you got to be able to think instead of thinking horizontally. You need to think in the lateral.
Ah.
I mean, a lot of people who are very resourceful don't think in a hierarchy. They think laterally.
Mm.
So if they're doing something and it doesn't work out, they go, okay, and then they go over to plan B, plan C, or they try different avenues of approach. Where the guy who thinks in a horizontal stack, he gets resistance. He just quits.
Yeah. When you're young and dick thick, it's important to have a backup plan. You know, because, you know, I know plan A is slot C. Plan C is slot A. But if you spend too much time on plan A, you're going to need yourself some plan B.
Well, that was just saying. Well, the thing is that level of that way of thinking was huge in the special forces.
Yes.
Because, okay, we got to do this. All right, we can't do this. Okay, I saw this. Let's steal that and get this done. Oh, you know. You roll into some warehouse and roll out with a couple pallets of foods, throw them in the back of a plane, land them somewhere and give them out because you said you're going to do that. And then they're bitching about the food getting stolen. You're like, I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sorry it happened. You know, it had to happen. We needed it done.
It had to be done.
Yeah, because, you know, asking for permission is that up and level, you know, the hierarchy thinking.
It's
forgiveness
ask,
is latitude.
Exactly. Asking for forgiveness is a much better idea. So when I shoot weddings, half the time I don't ask for permission before I do stuff. And then, and then at the end, they'll be like, you know, you really weren't supposed to be up there. It's like, well, this is really the best place to ask for forgiveness. So I hope you will forgive me.
Well, and you should answer, you only have one, you're only going to do this one time in your life, allegedly.
Allegedly, yeah.
You want it done right. There's some idiots out there that do it 2, 3, 4 times.
Oh, there are times when I walk in and I'm just like, oh, this is not going to be your first. Or this is not going to be your only, that's for sure.
I remember you scolded me that time. One of your, you were still on Facebook with one of the people you're getting married, did a wedding for.
Yeah.
And I told them.
Well, they weren't married yet.
I told them, get ready to live in
the refrigerator box. And she's like, who is this mother fornicator?
She was mad.
Yeah. She doesn't remember who you are anymore.
So. It doesn't matter. I don't care. They're going to throw a drink in my face. It's not like that's happened about a dozen times.
So how many sausages have you had in you at the same time?
Yeah, that was hilarious.
That was a good day.
Yeah, the response, my response was like over the top.
Yeah.
Because I maintained chill.
Chill. Chill is important to maintain.
Yep, latitude and laughter.
Yes.
Oh, man.
We're dropping a lot of truth bombs today. That's what happens when Pop has a full menagerie at the bar instead of just a foo-foo drink.
That's right.
What are we drinking tonight? What do you got?
Let's see. I got a mixed drink with some Red Bull. I have Jack Daniels, Winter Jack.
Yeah, that's all you. It's
basically, they freeze a bunch of apple hard cider.
Yeah.
And then they squeeze it out. The alcohol comes out. And then the rest of the water is frozen.
Mm.
That shit's really good. If you have too much of that, you're going to get a killer hangover.
Oh, yeah.
And then I just got a light beer. It's Miller Lite.
Light beer. Have your car towed all the way to your house, and all you got for me is light beer?
I love that show.
I love that shit. Back to the Future, one of my favorite movies of all time. Biff, I think one of the top 10 movie villains. The guy's awesome.
Yeah, but you know what? Most of the guys that were dicks to me when I was growing up are just average schleprocks today.
Oh, yeah.
I left them in the dust decades ago.
And most of them really are, Biff at the end of the movie. You know, they're out there waxing your car,
Yep.
You know, while you're waxing there the prom queen's ass in the house.
It does happen.
It does happen.
Yep.
You know what else happens? And this, we weren't even going to talk about this. And then all of a sudden, somebody just shot this shit over to me. And I was like, what in the mother fornication is this? This is the snake eating its own tail right here.
All right.
Twitch, owned by Amazon, stunning and brave, because we're broadcasting to that platform as we speak, pulls Amazon's anti-union ads. Twitch says the ads from its parent company should never have been allowed to run.
Wow. Yeah. You know, we're going to see more of that, you know, in the future.
Yeah.
Because you're going to have different, these big companies have different arms, and they're all going to fight amongst each other who can virtue signal the most.
Yes. And it's going to be a rampaging shit show.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, just within the last few years, we started hearing the term, you know, white feminism and things like that. So, I mean, it's just a matter of time before these people just start ripping each other to shreds.
I mean, that's
like the last pizza at a Weight Watchers convention.
I mean, it's going to happen.
Yep.
And you're going to see another thing is feminism is going to, you know, backlash against Islam, because Islam is the enemy to feminism.
A little bit.
And, you know, they were using the whole Islam thing to bring themselves, you know, higher up in the virtue signaling world.
What about that chick who says that, you know, the religion of peace is the most feminist religion?
Yeah, sure. As you're walking around in a black bedsheet with only your eyes exposed.
I mean, I've heard of somebody living in an echo chamber, but that's like living in an echo panic room. And you let no one else in, and you just think what you want to think.
Yeah, I mean, that's insane. I don't know, man. I was over in Iraq. I saw how they treated their ladies, and it wasn't good.
No. It's about one notch up from how they treat their stunning and brave alphabet community. You know, the LGBTQ, WTF, LOL people.
Yeah, you can't,
I believe I can
try.
That's
right. I was just going to say that.
I believe I can claw.
I watched that video, and I was just like, wow, that's a whole other level of evil right there.
Well, you know.
Remember we got the strike for showing the violence?
Oh, yeah.
Executions?
Yeah. You're not allowed to show people the truth.
It was the woman in combat one? Was it?
Yes. Pulse Kebab, we know that MGTOW.TV is down. My apologies. I think there was some kind of an IP address switch in my computer. I tried to sign everything in here. I got everything up and running. At least I thought I did. But apparently those two alt-tech platforms were not in the shuffle, even though they're... I did check Streamlabs and the RTMP is in there, so...
We'll work it out.
I got nothing for you.
We'll
no
work it out.
You
know, listen, this is what, the first week of the two live streams a week?
Yeah, this is the first week of two live streams a week.
It's going to be hiccups, gentlemen.
Shit happens, you know.
You know, it's not like we have a big budget or anything. This is like a shoestring as it gets.
Yeah, the only thing that I don't like about... Streamlabs, because it's really cool. It helps me keep a lot of things consolidated to where I can read the chat and still look at other stuff. But unlike just regular OBS, where you can start a stream and then activate it on a platform after you can be sure that it's working, This is just go live.
Yeah, that is annoying.
Hope for the best.
Yeah, hiccup number one. And also, you know, you got to understand, Murphy is real.
Oh, yeah.
Listen.
And he has an 18-inch stainless steel strap on that he keeps outside in the blistering cold.
You know who Murphy works for, right?
The man.
No.
He works for Whitey.
He works for Whitey.
Yes. Who works for the man.
And Whitey works for the man. So there's a whole network.
So
that
even
goes
Murphy
on.
Has a fucking bureaucracy.
That's right.
You can't escape it. Son of a bitch.
Every morning, Murphy gets a fax of all the people he's going to fuck with. He's like, oh, Pop's on there. I haven't fucked with him in a while. And he shows up. My car doesn't start. I lose my keys. I lock my car with the keys in there, and it's running. I've done that before.
I don't know how you can bang so many people in one day. He must have like a hula skirt cock.
He's
got like a whole bunch of them, and he just runs around
hammering you
like a lawn sprinkler, just bazooka juicing everyone right in the face,
hammering you,
hammered.
Hmm.
Shit, man. He's just like the enforcer in a hockey game. He just goes around hip-checking you in the ass with his big hula skirt of cocks.
Oh, my God. What's the next one? Talking about too many cocks here.
Too many cocks.
This isn't like a rangerette in the day room, man. This is too many cocks.
This is way too many cocks. All right. Well, I'm going to leave it up to you because we got two rather big stories today that I know everybody's been talking about. Actually, one of them, not so much. But the other one, everybody's been talking about it, and that's the COVID stimulus. And then the other is, Beijing Biden, recruiting the military and the DOJ now to combat white supreme pizza, utilizing the Patriot Act to spy on everyone and everything.
Well, they've already doing that.
Oh, yeah, but now they're just, instead of having legit threats to national security, now where when you sound like, the Beatles hippie, peace and love. Go on with peace and love in your hearts. Don't stay. Walk peacefully. That's become inciting violence now.
Yeah, I know.
Now anything. Use the Patriot Act, weaponize the FISA courts, which is exactly how we got the bullshit Steele dossier. So.
Yep.
But it's coming our way now. Guys like you and me.
Well, they're going to basically just, if you're white, they're going to probably just put a crosshair on your balls and be dead nuts on you.
Dead on balls accurate.
Yeah, I mean.
It's an industry term.
It's insane. I mean, this whole, spying on everyone thing, it's got me really creeped out.
It is quite creepy. Because we all know what people do while they're sitting at their computers with that camera uncovered.
Oh, no, I cover all my cameras.
You cover all your cameras.
Yeah, there'll be none of that.
I just wanted to imagine. Nobody wants to see that. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I don't partake in that anyway. But just in case,
I
cover all the cameras
allegedly.
Yeah, allegedly. Yeah, it's funny. Yeah, it's a funny thing. As you get older, it's the orange pace just doesn't really have the same impact.
It just doesn't do it for you anymore.
No, because you're thinking with this head. Yeah. So you're looking at the screen. You're like, yeah, she's really hot, and the big head's like. Yeah, that's $2,000 a month to maintain that.
Yeah.
You're like, you hit it, once a week? You're paying $500 a hit? It's not worth it.
Yeah, yeah. Her makeup cabinet looks like your supplement cabinet.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, because they want a real man, and they have their push-ups and their Spanx, and they have the whole, gun spray kit, like a bump and grind shop.
Bump and grind.
So they walk out the door, they're totally artificial, but they want that real man.
A real man, yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. <I'm> just,
so why don't we just rip into the stimulus thing?
We could talk about the stimulus. It is anything but stimulating.
I'm going to start off here. All right. So they're basically forking out trillions upon trillions of dollars.
$1.9 trillion for this one. And that's in addition to, I forget exactly what the last one was, but at last count, there was still $900 billion of it untouched.
I know.
But
what's
happening to that?
But the last stimulus, they give you a $600 check.
Yeah.
Where the fuck did the rest of the money go? It went to bullshit.
Anywhere but here.
The money's being handed out by a bunch of women who buy bullshit and crap. I mean,
it's being handled out by people who have taken a career and they become career embezzlers.
Yes.
But they give it a public relations friendly label like senator.
Uh-huh. Well,
representative.
In my opinion, everyone up there is a traitor to include the Supreme Court.
Concur.
All of them.
Why did it take this long for Clarence Thomas to pull his head out of his ass and say, we really missed an opportunity to make sure that people thought that this election was fair and conducted with everybody's best interests at heart?
Oh, I know.
What?
Well, okay, because they know they fucked up.
A day late and a dollar short on
that
one.
They got fences and barbed wire around the White House and the federal building, or where the Senate meets and shit. Congress.
That is the difference between a president who was elected and one who was fortified.
Correct. But the thing is they're trying to roll it back and go, hey, we're going to really make this look like it's legitimate now. And we're going to start looking into stuff. And they're not really going to look. They're just giving you, they're pouring a bunch of sand on the floor and they're giving you the soft shoe dance. I've seen it. I've heard it hundreds of thousands of times in 30 years in the Army. Okay.
They can smurf my balls.
There's no way there's absolutely no way they're going to be able to rebuild the confidence in the system.
No.
They're not. It's not going to happen. It's only going to get worse.
No, they can suck it and swallow like good little bitches that they are.
It's only going to get worse.
It is. It is only going
to
get worse.
In my opinion, I think everyone needs to turn their back on the GOP and start a Patriot Party where people actually care about the country. They want to bring jobs back, and they want to stop doing business with, you know, the CCP and all the bullshit they're doing.
Yep.
I mean, do you know how many jobs we'd get back if we just said, you know what, that cargo ship with all that stuff that's being made overseas, turn around and go back.
Yep.
Okay, and then sooner or later, demand would grow here. We're like, hey, you know what, that's a good idea. Let's build a factory here.
Yeah.
Hey, we're making, and then before you know it, we're making electronics. We're making more computer chips.
Yeah.
You know, we're making our own, you know, engines and all the shit we used to do.
Mm-hmm. I mean, so your crapple products, and I say this knowing full well how ironic that is. Everybody knows what we're working on right here.
Yeah, yeah.
But they'd be a little more expensive. Well, you know what? They're already way fucking overpriced.
Correct.
So, you know what? Demand for those drops, guess what has to drop in response to it?
I would love to see.
A free market does work, but that's not what we have anymore. We have a series of vertical monopolies. Most of the shit that you buy, that you ingest, you know, but whether it be media, you know, purchasing, what have you, is owned in some way by six parent companies. It's insane. Yes.
Because when you look at capitalism and communism, they both go to the same place. Have a handful of people pulling the strings for everything.
Yeah.
And that needs to stop. That's absolute bullshit.
Yep. And this kind of a system that we have right now, which is not end-stage capitalism, despite what the left would love to have us believe, this type of multinational corporate oligarchy is only possible with intense amounts of government regulation and intervention. This is a far-left system that we are seeing ripping our country apart.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with a free market. This is the absence of a free market that is causing problems. You know,
here's the good and the bad news. The bad news is they're going to keep doing this until it gets to the point where you can't work, can't feed your kids, you can't drive your car, you can't heat your house. And the good news is that's when people are going to wake up. And then it's going to get real bad.
Yeah. And they're hoping that in the meantime, with Sheila Jackson Lee's new gun bill, that they can take enough of the weapons away before that happens. Because they know that it's inevitable. If they're smart.
Yeah.
If they're not just greedy bastards, which we know
they've been trying to take the guns away from the American population since, like, what, the 70s.
It's been an incremental degradation of our rights ever since then. Yeah. Well, it's just this. You know, it's just the big scary guns. Well, now it's just the silencers and the bump stocks. Well, now it's just, you know, you don't need a magazine that has that many in it. You know, we can go with something smaller, and then sooner or later it's going to be, well, I mean, really all you need is like BBs and thumbtacks.
Yeah, I mean, that's really going to happen. That's what they want.
And, I mean, you can defend your home with a slingshot and walnuts, right?
I can do it.
You would probably pound nails into the walnuts and be like, ah!
No, I would have those big like steel ball bearings that go through drywall.
Oh,
I would hammer you so hard. You wouldn't even hear it.
Oh, yeah.
You'd be like, hey, what's going on? Bam.
Bam.
Yeah,
done.
I'm bouncing off your skull, you're done. You're going to either wake up in the ER or you're going to wake up dead.
Jail.
I'm just saying, those things are pretty deadly.
Yes, they are. So, but we should talk about some of the stuffing, because that's a more accurate thing than even just saying the stuff that's in this new stimulating bill here.
Let's go through some of this here.
And my personal favorite, because this is the one that the left loves to say is all about compassion for the little guy, is the federal minimum wage increase that would have a mandated $15 an hour by 2025. Because that worked out so great in Seattle.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to be honest here. They don't want any capitalism. They want to go to a socialist type of government.
Yep.
All right. That's not going to work. It's never worked in the past. It's not going to work now.
No.
You should let the market forces work out the prices for shit. The supply and demand and stuff like that. If there's a short supply of workers, yeah, they have to pay people more to get them in. If there's a whole lot of workers because they want to bring in all of these illegal aliens now, guess what?
Yep.
You're hammered.
I mean, this whole myth of a $15 minimum wage just providing a living wage and nothing else changes has been going around for years, and it's been debunked more than dragons and unicorns.
Correct.
And we've seen it put into practice in some of the liberal shitholes in the country, like Seattle. And what always happens? The same thing that happens when Bernie Sanders said, okay, well, you know, I suppose, you know, if I say that it needs to happen, I need to give it to you guys. But in order to do that, I got to cut your hours and I got to fire like three of you. So too bad, so sad. Take your shit and go.
He actually got rid of like 30% of his staff.
Yeah. That's what happens.
Yeah.
And you ever wonder why it's always politicians and big corporations that are pushing this bullshit?
I know. But here's the, if you really want to see people be able to earn a living wage, you need to bring the jobs back from overseas because they've all been shipped over there. That's why everyone is clamoring for a living wage job.
Yeah.
So the people who are singing the blues about not having a living wage need to, like, basically vote these assholes out and do some make some positive decisions in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I mean, literally, you got to bring the jobs back. I mean, it's just...
Bring the jobs back and get rid of a minimum wage completely. The reason why the big corporations are in favor of a $15 an hour minimum wage is because they will not hurt if it gets implemented. You know who's going to hurt? The same people that were destroyed during the scamdemic. Small businesses.
Which is the
that
heart.
That can't afford to do
it. And they're the heart of capitalism.
Yeah.
They're on the front lines of capitalism, the small and medium companies. Because the big corporations will be like, yeah, we got to pay our people more, but we won't have as much competition because, you know, these guys will all be gone, and all of those people will have to come here.
And the big corporations can afford to replace those $15 an hour employees with kiosks.
And robots.
Yeah. You know, the ones that get covered with so much fecal matter, it'll put you in the fucking hospital.
Yeah, I dare you guys to go there and lick that thing. Yeah.
Please don't do that. I mean, you've seen some of the viral video trends that happen in this godforsaken planet that we live on. Like the chick who licked the airplane toilet seat.
What?
Yes, you didn't see that
video?
No,
I don't want to see that, man.
No. You got a drinking straw up there?
No. Hey, no. I don't want to see that.
I mean, in all likelihood, she probably walked into the thing and wiped it down with sanitizer wipes and dried it off and then licked it. But
you
got to
be a special
kind
of stupid to do that kind of shit.
Yes. Ugh.
Or what about that one woman that was opening the ice cream and licking them and putting them back, and they filmed her?
Ugh.
She actually got charged for that shit.
Yeah, and I think a long time ago there was this group of douchebags, not really a nasty thing, but they were just filming themselves throwing iPods and iPads in the back of a fucking Walmart, like shattering them on the floor while they're in the box, and then just putting them out on the shelf. Guess who's getting fired?
Yeah, you are getting charged. Because those are expensive.
Since when did it become standard operating procedure for people to film themselves doing stupid shit?
Because most people out there are stupid.
I know that, but it just doesn't make it... Not every thought you have or activity you engage in requires being documented for the entire world to gather around a phone or a computer or whatever and appreciate how ridiculous you are.
Yep. You are correct. But,
yeah. Note to the OnlyFans chicks out there.
There's a lot of stupid people out there who do crazy stuff and they think it's going to be okay, and then it comes back to bite them in the ass.
Speaking of OnlyFans chicks. Oh, it'll be just fine. You know, I'm going to be able to pay for my apartment. I'm going to move out. I'm going to have my own house at 19. What do you mean you won't hire me? What?
Yep. Or like me. Like, if I find out a woman I'm interested in had any part in working in the sex industry, it's a wrap.
Done.
It ends there. I'm not doing it.
No.
I just can't do it.
I can't do it. Can't do it. So, federal minimum wage increase, that's one of the biggies. This one I don't understand. Animal COVID studies It allocates $300 million of the taxpayer dollars to the Agriculture Department to conduct monitoring and surveillance of susceptible animals for incidence of SARS-CoV-2, as guided by the World Organization for Animal Health.
Well, one, unless there's something we don't know, that's completely unnecessary.
Yeah.
Now,
I mean, was it Sweden or something where they found that minks could get it? And then they just nuked their entire mink population, like put them all in a hole and flame broiled them with a thrower.
I don't know. I personally think that maybe if they're putting that money aside, there might be something they know that we don't know.
Yeah.
Like for instance,
maybe they want to. I mean, I'm not saying that this was created. But I am saying that from what I understand, ever since, we know about the only lab in China where this came from, right?
Uh-huh.
And has since had its taxpayer funding from our country renewed for it by a certain stunning and brave, completely not demented and totally doesn't sniff your granddaughter president. Maybe this is an extension of that.
I don't know. But
if you can't get humans to do it.
But listen. I read some of the investigations into this. When you screw with the DNA of an organism, it leaves behind a fingerprint.
Yes.
And they literally looked at the DNA of the COVID, and you can see the snip marks where things were taken out and put in.
Mm.
So.
Totally a naturally occurring phenomenon.
Yeah, I mean, for something to jump from an animal to human, does it happen? Yes.
Yeah.
But typically, if it's going to jump from an animal to a human, the first time it does it, it's not a big deal.
Yeah.
And then once it gets a foothold in that human and it's able to spread, then it starts to get, nasty. But most of the time, it gets one or two people, it doesn't get spread around, and it's a done deal.
Is anybody else hungry for some bat soup?
You're drinking wine out of the bottle?
Oh. Yes, I am. It's going to go bad while I'm on vacation. Wah.
All right.
And we got another one here. Okay, now this one. Now, if you don't know what's going on, if you don't know that a certain stunning and brave Microsoft creator is now currently the number one owner of farmland in this country, it's going to sound compassionate. Socially disadvantaged farmers and ranchers. Addressing farm loans, the bill states that the Agriculture Department shall provide a payment of an amount equal to 120% of the outstanding indebtedness of each socially disadvantaged farmer or rancher as of January 1st, 2021, to pay off the loan directly or to the socially disadvantaged farmer or rancher.
What is socially disadvantaged?
That's actually a very good question I hadn't thought of before, but considering who is writing this...
It could be all minorities.
It could be all minorities, exactly, because now we have Google and, hell, one of my business that I do event videography for is on businesses, it's on websites like Wedding Wire and The Knot, and now they actually allow you to eliminate possibilities from your search parameters based on whether or not a business is gay or minority-owned.
Yeah. That's ridiculous.
So that could be the socially disadvantaged you're talking about.
That's a huge thing. If you don't know what that means, if that's not defined, it could literally be anything.
Son of a bitch.
You got your feelings hurt. Here's $120,000.
Yeah. So so Bill Gates, for all we know, could start to he might have bought all this stuff up just knowing that this was coming down the pipe and getting a nice bit of his indebtedness for purchasing the land paid off.
Yep. And in the future, when food starts to become scarce, people are holding on to this land and not growing on it. They're going to be called to task.
Yes.
Like if you want to buy a bunch of farmland, okay, grow some shit on it. There you go.
Yeah.
What a dumbass. All right, what's the next one?
Or like Sam Kinison said, if you're living in one of these countries where they don't have any food and, like an American semi-truck has to drive in there like once a month and drop off the food, you're like, no. Stop doing that. Stop sending these people food. You know what you do? You take one truck over there, you load them all into the back, and then we're going to take you to where the food is!
Or you can grow your own...
Get in the back! One trip! That's all you need!
Nothing fucking grows out here.
I love that. See this? It's sand. You know, it'll be in 100 years. It'll be sand.
It'll be sand.
Yeah, that was funny, man. That guy was gold.
Oh, man. God bless you, Sam Kinison. I miss that guy, man. Yeah. Every time I watch Back to School, I'm like, damn, that was a funny motherfucker.
I love that. That's a good movie. I love that movie.
That was some good stuff, too. Both of those guys. Miss them both. Rodney Dangerfield and Sam Kinison, both. Comedy legends.
No respect.
There's one, of course, you're going to have to, you expect on this. You know, it's one of the Democrats' prize ponies for trying to trot out to convince people that they actually care about little people. Student loan outreach. $91 million for that. $135 million for the National Endowment for the Arts.
All right.
I mean, most people take boner pills,
hang on. All right. Art.
Art.
In reality, art doesn't fill any basic needs whatsoever. Most people who try to earn a living doing art usually barely get by, live in poverty, because art does not pay. It doesn't. So if we're going to be having all these economic troubles coming up, it kind of makes sense to, like, you know what?
I hate it when the button doesn't work.
We can just, like not send money to the arts and work on some other stuff, like, getting people food, trying to make more jobs, fix the economy.
Or if you want to be an artist, you can figure out a way to make that art make money for you.
Yep. But the thing is like, I'm sure there's a lot of people you went to school with who are not making a living right now. They're doing something else.
Oh, yeah. Of everybody who, you know, I never bought a yearbook, but, you know, people showed me theirs and shit like that. So everybody talked about what it was they wanted to do when they grew up. Out of everybody that I went to school with, I think I am maybe one of 10 who's actually doing what he set out to do.
And you're not done yet.
I'm not done yet. I'm just ramping up.
Yep.
It's going to get lively up in the air.
Hell yeah.
Winning. Oh, here we go. Another $200 million to the Institute of Museum and Library Services.
All right.
There's another one for you.
That's what, wipe your ass and flush that down the toilet.
And this is one of the things that perplexes me the most here. Native American languages. The bill also gives $10 million for the preservation and maintenance of Native American languages. You know what else preserves and maintains languages? Speaking them.
Yeah.
So what the fuck is $10 million going to do? I'm just asking for a friend.
I don't know. I mean, that's $10 million bucks. I'm not really opposed to, like, them maintaining their culture and language.
No, that's all well and good, but $10 million is not going to help them do that any better.
Have you ever been on the Indian reservation?
Negative.
That place is like, you cross the border in there, and it's like two man enter, one man leave land. It is crazy. Because when I used to fight, I fought at a lot of Indian casinos. So you drive in there, you're like, what the fuck is this? Oh, it's crazy. It's not as bad as, you know, red trash land, but it was pretty close.
Yeah, I call them casino owner Americans. Stunning and brave.
They got a good scam.
They do.
They got a good scam.
Here we go. Vaccine information. This one should scare people a little bit. $1 billion. $1 billion to strengthen vaccine confidence in the United States. In other words, propaganda.
Propaganda. That's exactly
provide
what that
further
is.
Information and education with respect to vaccines. Propaganda, and improve rates of vaccination throughout the United States. In other words, probably trying to force you to do it or hiding it in other shit.
Yeah, I'm not really, I'm not up for that. Not doing it.
Not so much.
No. If they say I have to get it, I will go to a certain doctor of Russian persuasion, and I'll say, well, just write it in my chart that you gave it to me.
Although it is really hilarious how in just the last year, we have seen all of these California stan anti-vaxxers flip on a dime. You know, the ones who are all anti-establishment, I'm a Bernie bro, anti-vaxxers, you know, fuck the man, blah, blah, blah. But then as soon as this happened, You better stay home and wear your mask. You know, they look like a fucking armadillo with all the masks on their damn face, and they're all just eager to bend over and get their anal swab. All
right, so you're talking about the COVID thing. All right.
Kung flu.
Let's just touch on that for a while. All right. They were so successful at scaring the absolute shit out of the entire United States population. They're going to keep milking this.
Oh, yeah.
For years. And they're going to use it as an excuse to keep doing all kinds of horseshit to us.
You know what? That's
completely unnecessary.
That is a perfect segue into this next article here. Klaus Schwab, and we're going to get back into the rest of the stimulus bill, admits that the plan is for life never to return to normal.
Yeah, how long? Is that a video?
We are just going back to the good old world, which we had. And everything will be normal again in how we are used to normal, in the old fashion. This is, let's say, fiction. It will not happen. Cut which we have now is much too strong in order not to leave traces.
Yep.
I know. I just want to keep doing. They're going to keep. Listen, this is the club they're going to beat us all to death with.
Yep. Hey, well, it was a good ride while it lasted. The great experiment is burning in.
I guess.
Man, George Carlin called it before he died well over 10 years ago.
Yes.
He's like, this country's finished. It's burning in. It's going to take a while, but it's happening.
He was, well, I knew it was coming when I was like, in my late teens. Yeah, I remember like one day, like in high school, I'm walking out the front door. It's a nice brisk fall day.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, something bad is going to happen.
There's people in the chat saying that Klaus, you know, with that strong German accent makes him sound so trustworthy.
I know.
Ich weiß, ich weiß, nein, 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 nein.
Oh, my God. All right, let's get back to the stimulus.
I don't know what people are saying about poor old Klaus, but I do not see the issue here.
That wouldn't be the first time the Germans tried to take over the world.
True story. Hamster in the chat.
All right, Hamster Man.
Thank you very much for joining us there, James. What else we got? Oh, God. See, this is why I deliberately don't read all these things in detail sometimes, because I like to be genuinely and, you know, pleasantly surprised or perhaps mortified. Family planning, which could include a abortion, $50 million.
So we're paying for it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And one of the executive orders that Biden signed overturned one that Trump put in place that prevented abortions from being funded in other countries. Because here we have the Hyde Amendment,
yes,
which doctors circumvent all the time for medical reasons. But now we're just flat out funding abortions in other countries. Stunning and brave.
That's such bullshit.
Bullshit.
I'm sick and tired of America forking out money to all these countries, all the bullshit. If I was running the show, that would come to a screeching halt.
Yeah.
Fuck NATO. They're done. They can kiss my ass.
Oh, God. Here we go. The Centers for Disease Control is continuing to rip us off. $750 million to the CDC.
Well, yeah, which Fauci's going to get his hands on.
Of course, yeah. And Julia Roberts is giving him an award for all of his stunning and brave flip-flopping that he's been doing for the past year.
You know what? That'd be funny if we could find out where he lived and mail him some flip-flops.
Or we could just mail him a Pringles can full of shit.
Yeah, they DNA test that shit, you know.
Well, you could always, you know, you got a big dog,
yeah,
living with you in that. Your place over there. You could scoop up the dog shit and send that to him in a Pringles can.
Yeah, I know. But
because,
you know,
the insinuation would still be there. Once you pop,
yeah,
the fun don't stop.
Nah, I think sending him a pair of flip-flops would be more symbolic.
Nah, now send him the Pringles can full of shit and send it media mail so it takes like a week to get there. So by the time it gets there, it's going to be all seeping out the sides and stuff. Just make sure you wrap it in something.
They won't deliver it if it's doing that.
But you put it inside of like something, I don't know. Why you figure it out.
I'll figure it out if I'm going to do it.
You could like, you know, paint like a, you know, spray paint it with like a gloss finish or something that would seal in the flavor, if you know what I mean.
That's horrible.
I know.
I'd have to use kills.
You could prepackage like a few maggots and flies in there, so when he opens it up, it's like confetti coming out.
Yeah. You know what kills is, right? It's a paint that they used to paint inside houses to seal in all the bullshit.
Oh.
Yeah, I think that would do it.
Ah.
Ew. Yeah. Lateral thought.
Oh, this one's interesting. Oh. This next one is interesting here. Health surveillance. $500 million
half a billion dollars.
To support public health data surveillance and analytics infrastructure modernization initiatives at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. You know, that's really only one letter acronym away from CCP.
Correct.
In fact, I would say that's a pretty accurate description for that stunning and brave organization over the past year, the Centers for Control and Prevention.
Well, the thing is...
of actual capitalism.
I mean, literally, all of the deaths we're supposed to have didn't happen.
Yep.
If you look at the actual total deaths, it's very close to the year before it.
Yep.
You know, we're hearing all these stories about these deaths being, you know, overcounted.
Every single year in the winter, every media outlet from coast to coast... and, you know, the border to border in every Western country always throws caution to the breeze and starts talking about how, you know, our health system is in dire straits because it's flu season and we have a shortage of beds and everything. It's every single year like clockwork. This is no different.
So
it's
different.
Just a new thing.
And like I've said before, if it was as deadly as they predict, it would have wiped out the homeless population.
But you know what it did wipe out? It wiped out pneumonia, the flu, and the common cold.
Yeah.
They're all just yahoo now.
They're gone now.
Gone.
It's such bullshit. If you just take the time to look at the numbers, you can see the truth.
Yeah. I mean, I work with a cop who told me flat out that he has done the paperwork, witnessed traffic accidents with fatalities and whatnot. He has filled out the reports himself, explained exactly what happened. He goes to finalize his report later, gets it back from the coroner, listed with EIU on it. No reason.
No reason.
Has nothing to do with the actual cause of death, but there it is anyway.
That's that's crazy.
Am I drinking out of the bottle, Pulse Kebab? Yes, I am. I am taking a note from our buddy Jimmy, who's also in the chat. Only mine isn't shaped like a skull.
Nice.
I'm going full bore tonight.
What's the next one?
Well, airlines. Speaking of which, I'm going to grab another article after reading this one.
Okay.
Airlines. The airlines industry, which was controversially bailed out in the first stimulus last spring, gets another $15 billion with a B.
$15 billion?
Billion.
Are you kidding me?
I kid you not.
Holy shit. That is unacceptable.
Unacceptable.
That is bullshit.
They were already like running themselves into a freaking, you know, spiraling into the shitter.
Yeah, they were.
Running their own business into the hole.
Well, you know, it is what it is. I'm not a fan of flying, but I do it from time to time.
Yeah.
But hey, I mean, you know, you got to come up with a better way to do it, or you go out of business.
You got to do what you do. And when you do choose to fly during this particular time, and if you are a melting snowflake who can't handle the truth, don't write an article about it for Business Insider called...
I flew Southwest for the first time since it stopped blocking middle seats. The friendly service didn't make up for the inconsistent social distancing practices.
Now, take a look at this face. Mask or not, this dude is a big enough bundle of sticks to start his own bonfire.
Yep.
And when you write an article like this, when you are voluntarily getting onto a flying sardine can with some of the worst air circulation on record, and you do it willingly, don't bitch about it. If it's that bad, if you're that wham wham crybaby gimme money, take the train.
Yep.
I used to take the train. And pretend you have Tourette's if you don't want to sit near people, right?
Yeah, I took the train all the time. No problem.
The Tourette story is one of my favorite things that you've ever done. I thought it was an absolute stroke of genius. Almost as genius as our photographer buddy Keith sent me a photo. The dude, what he does is he actually kept the envelope from a parking ticket that he had.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever he parks somewhere for a protracted length of time, he sticks it under his windshield wiper and then just walks away. They never give him a ticket because they think he already has one.
Nice.
Somebody give that dude a trophy.
Oh, my God.
That is brilliant.
How many people we have watching?
We have over 1,000 people watching.
Holy shit. That's
awesome. We are actually at 1010.
Right.
Which is what, you know, when they're trying to teach you English in China and you really don't know how to say it, you get up to 20 and you go, 1010? 1010-1? Or you get up to 100. 1010-1010. I've seen that viral video. It's hilarious, but I'm just saying. 1010-1, 1010-2, 1010-3. How much does a blowjob cost? 1010-1.
Yeah, they're a lot cheaper over there from what I understand.
You know it's what?
No, I think in Thailand you can get one for like 60 baht or whatever. Yeah.
Everybody's talking about the sign. It's the champagne of beers, James.
What, the beer?
You ginger hamster.
It's Miller, man.
Oh, my God. I remember, yeah, like this is actually, this is a vintage sign. It's older than I am. My brother had it hanging up in the bar in his basement when he was living with his ex-hooer. And when he wanted to get rid of it, he just gave it to us as like a contribution to the show. So I held on to it. But it was the first beer I ever drank when I was 17 and I had a party at my house.
It's not bad. It's all right.
It's pretty damn bad.
it doesn't bother me. They all taste like piss to me. But
well, I mean, you're drinking Miller Lite right now.
I still drink it. I can drink anything. I don't give a shit.
Oh, it's just so bad.
I'm not drinking for flavor. I'm drinking for effect, bro.
Well, I've got better beer in the fridge if you insist, sir.
No, I'm good.
No, I'm good. I want to drink my piss.
I'll drink my warm water down piss that's light on calories. I mean,
you actually came in here talking like Jack Black and the Tenacious D album. Like, oh, you know, I will drink that regular beer, but I got to watch my figure. I'll go, what's the calories, bruh?
Well, listen, a normal beer is the equivalent of a ham sandwich. You drink a six-pack, you just basically ate a rack of sandwiches.
Oh, yeah. And some of the really intense beers, it's like the equivalent of eating like 4 to 7 slices of bread.
Yeah, you're eating like basically 2 big submarine sandwiches.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's good times.
All right, we went off on a tangent there.
On a tangent here, but we're going to go back to the stimulus for one quick go, and then we are going to hit some super chats with you guys.
All right.
The last thing, and it kind of surprised me that the Blaze did not cover this when they were going through and kind of outlining everything that's in the stimulus, but this is a real good one here. It really just goes to show you the sheer insanity that exists over there on Capitol Hill. Pelosi's $1.9 trillion bill includes up to $21,000 bonus for federal workers whose kids or family members are impacted by the virus. So the rest of you, and the last stimulus, you get $600.
Yep.
But federal workers, most of whom have not lost their job during this time, none of them have been unemployed,
get $20,000.
$21,000.
That is, wow.
And then look at this fucking Skeletor. Looks like somebody stretched a latex condom over Meryl Streep's skeleton. It's disgusting. Oh, yeah. The Democrat bill gives federal workers an extra $21,000 if they have kids out of school or loved ones affected by the coronavirus. Wow. So, yeah, and Gateway Pundit puts it best here. This is exactly what socialist hellholes do. Government workers get the goodies. The rest of society suffers.
That's right. Enjoy it while it lasts.
Enjoy it while it lasts. We're burning in. Burning in.
Yes, we are.
I can smell the soy.
It's not going to be pretty.
It's not going to be pretty at all. It's going to be bad news bears.
Yeah, big bad news bears.
Big bad news bears. So, yeah, this COVID relief stimulus bill, it's just as bad as the rest. And from what I understand, and I think I mentioned this earlier, the last stimulus bill still has $900 billion completely unallocated. It's just sitting there.
Yeah, it's going to wind up going into the Black Ops slush fund, and we have no idea where that money will go.
It's going to go to Nancy Pelosi's next 15 facelifts as she attempts to utilize organs that were totally legally harvested in the stunning and brave CCP land of the Yahoo, you know, to try to survive until she's 150.
Like at the 9/11 event, that happened just prior to them, you know, releasing a report that there was like $1 or $2.3 trillion that they couldn't account for. And then all of a sudden, you know, some buildings collapse. And
yeah.
We forget about it.
It's like Independence Day. You don't really think they spend $20,000 on a hammer, $30,000 on a toilet seat, do you?
I mean, there's some crazy-ass shit that happened there.
Yes, there is. Somebody said the audio shut off like a minute ago. Are you guys still not hearing us on YouTube? Everybody seems to be hearing us just fine. You might have a buffer issue on your side. Try reloading.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Now. What about Facebook? Is Facebook working?
Do we have anybody watching us on Facebook?
We had a lot of follows hitting us on Facebook when we first started. So
really?
Yeah, I think there's some people watching on there.
All right.
All right. But we're going to get into some chats.
Yeah.
And, of course, the man with the plan, the man with the Unabomber beard, but we love him, no homo, Polska Bob, $25 donated before the stream even started. Poppin' Blake, here's your booze money. Way ahead of you, brother. Cheers.
I just came in with some booze.
Booze?
Yeah, I spent about 20, 50 bucks on booze, yeah.
Yeah, you got some more of that, that salted caramel cream liqueur. That was just like,
yeah, plus I picked up a bottle of apricot brandy.
Apricot brandy.
Yeah.
Outstanding.
It's bottom shelf, but I'll still drink it.
If it works, I
don't care.
Like you said, you're not drinking it for flavor. You're drinking it for effect.
Yes, exactly.
Hey, Tracy Wilborn donated $5. Yeah, what'd I miss? Some dumbass with a stereo so loud it was making shit rattle in my place at least a block away. Enjoy being deaf by 30, you dumbass. Have a, well, at least most of a decent six on me. Cheers.
All right. I can't stand people that do that.
Yeah, I've never understood the idea of feeling your music to the point where your butthole puckers.
Yeah? You get a little tickle down there.
Yeah.
Boom.
You know the absolute worst, though?
Huh.
It's not the dudes that you see, you know, driving down the street in a 94 Buick that has chrome spinners on it and, you know, the trunk is jumping up and down with the hydraulic lifts and the subwoofer in the back that costs more than the car itself. Middle Eastern wedding DJs.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huh.
That is the kind of sound that makes your heart feel like it's about to stop.
Wow.
When you walk by the speakers.
That's a lot of watts right there.
Yeah. I did a wedding, took my wife to it. We were filming this whole thing, Middle Eastern wedding. These people, I don't know what they were thinking. It was obnoxiously loud. And by the time we left, I shit you not, we got all the equipment in the car. They're sitting down, and all of a sudden she's doing this because it's like she's got an itch, and she pulls her finger out. Blood was on her finger. It was so damn loud in there, it made her ear bleed.
It perforated her eardrum.
Yes.
Holy crap. That. Wow, that's like this. That usually doesn't happen unless you're like next to an explosive or something.
Yeah. I mean,
Holy crap. You're
doing what we do, we're constantly all over the place. We're walking right by the speakers. Sometimes you have to be stationed for like an entire event that has music right in front of it.
I couldn't do that. My PTSD would go off the chart.
Yeah.
I mean, I could put earplugs in and I'd be able to hang out for maybe 15 minutes.
Yeah. Well, anybody who's...
I'd have to leave. I could not do
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. And anybody who's been to a Middle Eastern wedding knows that, like, you know, if you've been to an American wedding, what normally happens is, like, they introduce in the wedding party, they play, like, one song, you know, but they basically come in, cut the cake, and go right to the table.
Uh-huh.
Middle Eastern weddings, they come in, and it's like a mosh pit on the dance floor for upwards of a half an hour straight. And the only way that you can actually prepare for that kind of a thing is to be up above it. And uh-huh. Where do you have to be for that? On the stage. So you're right there by the monitor speakers, and it's... By the time you're done, you can't hear shit.
You should bring earplugs, man.
I do.
All right.
I do. I have, like, gun headphones now that I wear with me. But still, man, I got to sleep with a fan on.
Oh, yeah. I got bad tinnitus.
It sounds like somebody's, you know, testing my hearing constantly.
Yeah, I got that, too.
Bad.
Yep. My hearing was perfect until I got blown up. And now, 24/7, 365.
Yeah, Matthew Ford said, you ever hear earplugs? We were wearing them. Thank you for playing.
Yeah. Then you hear a loud noise. It's like, oh, I hate that.
Yeah.
It never goes away. It never. Like, I left an earplug in this ear for like a month.
Yeah.
I took it out, still had it. It's never going to go away.
No, because what it is, you have these little hairs in your ear called cochlea. Okay. Now, when the cochlea gets damaged, either by physical force or intense vibration, your brain automatically compensates for the cochlea in your ear to amplify the ones that still work. That's where the ringing comes from.
Oh.
So there's nothing that's actually going to fix it.
Yeah, it's not going to fix.
I did videos for an ENT doc back in the day. Apparently I retained some of that knowledge. So winning.
All right. Yeah. Oh, my Lord. What's the next one?
It's good times here. Oh, yeah. Cilia, they attach to the cochlea. Yeah, Buckstar Chaser, you are correct. I'm sorry. It's all up in here, but it's not all 100% anatomically correct. What do we got here? Domesta, 012, $5. Earlier, I asked if women F their dogs. Now I have to ask, why? Is there an epidemic of bestiality among women? And why? Is it the dog's junk on constant display? Do they see it as schmecks without responsibility or consequence or something else?
Well, you know, one orgasm is just a scoop of peanut butter away for them.
Well, I mean, half of the women out there now are like, you know, identifying as feminists and letting their body hair grow out. It doesn't really look all that inviting.
Yep.
I mean, it's not exactly a Golden Corral down there. So what do? You get a dog and a jar of peanut butter, and you split the difference, I guess.
No, I'm telling you, like, that bestiality thing, that is just beyond nasty.
And they call themselves zoosexuals.
Yeah, whatever.
Interspecies erotica, fucko.
Yeah, you know, in the Bible, they catch you doing that, they put you to the sword.
Yeah.
That's the way it used to be.
Peanut butter and clam chowder with a drinking straw.
Oh, God.
Chrome Dome Omega, thank you for that mental image. I gave it to Pop just for you.
It's horrible.
I know. You're welcome.
God damn.
Atheist, $10. Corporatism is fetal communism. Corporations are communist and socialist by definition. They are publicly owned and traded communal property, the antithesis of private property.
Huh. Well,
like I said, this is not a capitalist society when you're talking about these big globalist corporations. Yeah. These companies are only possible because of far-left policies.
Yes and no. Yes and no.
Okay, explain how no.
Well, I mean, they still operate under capitalism, except they
as far as supply and demand, you would be correct.
Yes. But except they are slowly extinguishing the smaller businesses around them.
Yes.
And then
eliminate the competition,
and
then
they
you
go
have
to the same
on.
Place. They go to an what's it, oligarchy or whatever they call it. They go right. Communism does that, and capitalism does it when it gets high enough. It goes to the same place.
Good times.
That's bullshit, but it needs to stop.
Dumbaster again. It would be a lot easier to make money to live off of if it weren't for the government whoring itself out to the Federal Reserve for over a century and has made the dollar lose 95% of the value that it had 100 years ago. Amen.
I would have to agree with you.
Yep.
But, you know, the system that they had in place is failing, and it's going to blow up in everyone's face. And in my opinion, you know, JFK wanted to have it the Fed audited, and they arranged for him to get the JFK haircut.
Yes. And, yeah, I mean, I remember, you know, watching, you know, I Love Lucy and everything, and just looking at how inexpensive everything was. Like, wow, it's amazing. And then, you know, I started, you know, every once in a while, you know, Lucy drops $3,000 on new furniture. And I'm like, wow, what would that be like today? Because $3,000 is still a lot of money. You look it up, that would have been the equivalent of spending 30 grand.
I know.
Quite literally, 100% decrease in its value.
You should be able to buy houses for $3,000.
Yeah. And you know what? When it does all blow up in everyone's face, there's a hell of a lot more of us than there are them, and they need to remember that.
Yep. It's, I don't know. I don't know what they're thinking.
Yeah.
I think they're just drunk on power.
Yes. Yeah, I would tend to agree. Inquisitor Jack. Pop finalizing the care package from Maryland. Ever have any camping equipment that eats 40 ACP plus P? I can spare a box of Hornady Critical Duty.
I'll take it.
I'll be getting it sent out this weekend via FedEx. Emailing you about prepping in my area.
Excellent. I'm actually trying to put together a database of guys who are interested in putting together a national prepper database.
Yeah.
Because if this gets bad, you know, we're going to have a network within each state, and then they're going to be able, they got to be able to communicate with each other to figure out shit. Because, you know, when the zombie apocalypse happens, you just want to get out of their way until they run out of food and water.
Absolutely. FBO director donated. Blake, check out poopsenders.com. Also, you should send one to that guy you know getting all the dicks just to pile on.
Yeah, because, you know, that's what soldiers do. Soldiers always pile on.
Pile it on, man. They got to bust your balls.
Yeah, they always pile on.
All
right.
That's
what they do.
Moving over to YouTube, Crusader Nate donated $20. I would donate $500 to get the ball rolling for a challenge coin for fans. What else do I have to offer? Jameson cold brew with a drinking straw for Pop.
Ah, come on, the drinking straw.
And cruise tickets for Blake. All aboard the Cry-tanic,
that's
bitches.
A good burn, man. That's a good burn.
I like it. Bill Horvat, in the voice of Klaus Schwab, tell us how you are going to take over the world.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
Oh, man. That flow chart is huge. It got involved getting rid of the Pope.
We need to do like a whole stream on that.
There's other leaders that need to go. You need to change over parties.
Okay.
You know.
Let's just say it right now. Do you guys want to see a whole stream of what would happen if Pop took over the world? If you do, let us know, and I will make him write it up, and it will happen.
Oh, my God.
Because I think that the answer to that question is a lot more than the time that we would have left.
Yes.
Yes.
I don't sleep. I think about these things.
Yes. Well, the answer is an overwhelming hell yes. So I think we have the topic for our next stream.
Well, come on. It might take some time.
Man. Okay, fine. Well, you can do it. You have all weekend. You'll be
fine. Please. Yeah, you got a point there.
I'm going to be driving to Texas. You're not going to have me to antagonize. You can take some time.
Yeah.
Think about how you would take up as a vault. Of course.
Yeah, it can be done.
It can be done. Do it.
It could be. A lot of...
Maybe not Tuesday's stream, but next Thursday's. How about that?
I could probably do one if I was in charge. We could do that,
yeah.
But taking over the world, I mean, you know, that would require some. You know, for me to be totally honest, I'd wind up getting, you know, in trouble with people.
Well, you know, you just got to, you know, you run it by me first. We'll come up with some creative language, and we'll get it done.
Yeah.
We can make it happen.
All right. We'll see what happens.
All right. Or we could just, you know, get a chick with big tits to come in here and say it. You know, they're not going to ban them because they're stunning and brave.
All right.
Well, I don't know about brave, but, you know, some of them are stunning. Ben RP with a $10 donation. Thank you very much. Jeff on the Bound. Extreme camping pack made with a package of combat resupply freedom seeds. Looking forward to becoming part of the network of Pop's Misfit Rangers. Acta, non verba, sapa, clear the way.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm actually going to probably put together a Proton email, and then I get all the email addresses. I'll probably, you know, send them out newsletters and time schedules and shit like that. But the most important thing to do is, one, we have to communicate via email, maybe have a phone tree, and then we have a ham radios. If we have a national grid of ham radios that can always talk to each other, I think that'd be pretty good.
Yes.
Like I said... when you can't feed your family and people run out of, you know, the basics, when the zombie apocalypse starts, you just need to get the hell out of Dodge.
Yes.
And let it run its course until it's time to, you know, redirect shit.
Carl Jackson says, make him do it, Pinky. Take over the world.
Same thing we always do.
I think so, Brain, but where do they make burlap sacks in our size?
Yeah, like one of the big hammer and anvil things is that could kick it all off is actually taking place here. And I could explain that later.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Colso Peasant Rescue, $2. I would have hit all the utilities and then the pig pen. Narf.
Well, you know,
I've never tried to do Pinky before. How am I doing? Am I doing okay?
You're halfway into that wine?
I'm halfway into the wine, Brain. Narf.
I am so glad that Pinky and the Brain is back. I don't know if you guys have watched the revived Animaniacs on Hulu. I watched a couple of episodes. I'm actually pretty pleased.
Really?
They're making fun of the woke cancel culture.
Yeah, when I first got started in mortgages, I was working at a company, and the owner and this hit a right-hand guy, we referred to them as Pinky and the Brain. They were so effed up.
You know that dude on that show who does the voice of Pinky? He does like half the voices on the damn show, man. That is a talented dude. His name is, ironically enough, I think his name is Robert Paulson. Like the bitch tits dude from Fight Club.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Nah. Kilo Ninja 00, $5 chat. Hey, Pop, is there an update on that raid that happened in Germany and Spain to seize the Dominion servers? Nah.
To be honest with you, you know, I've heard a bunch of bullshit on this. They're saying it didn't happen, blah, blah, blah.
But people are dead. Provably. Yeah,
people have been reported dead. It was mentioned in the German media, and then it was cleaned up.
Of course.
And that data from the servers has been put into packets to support these lawsuits that the Supreme Court didn't want to see.
Shocker.
Uh-huh.
You want to smell it?
Yeah, and, you know, to be honest, hypothetically, allegedly, I might have actually looked at some of this data that was sent to Giuliani, and it went, and he was actually putting it in his pile of evidence. Mm-hmm. Now, I didn't, you know, I just intercepted a copy, allegedly, that he saw.
Allegedly.
So, I can't say yay or nay on that one, but it's, you know, it's pretty spooky.
Spooky. Yeah, we still got over 1,000 people watching. Thank you all for tuning in. But we only have 500 likes. See, now there, that I take issue with.
Yeah.
Hit that like button. It's one of the only things that helps us crack through this ridiculous algorithm.
Do we have our 15 downvotes?
I don't know. See, that part I don't get to see.
Okay. Because we always get 10 to 15 downvotes. I swear there's like ladies that watch this. All I do is that motherfucker.
I'm pretty sure one of them is your ex-wife.
Probably is. Probably is.
Maybe she's got two YouTube accounts that she logs in for your daughters and has them downvoted too.
Nah, my daughters, they don't want to shit. They don't watch this at all. They don't care.
Jail.
When they get older, they will. But you know, right
six
now,
six downvotes so far.
Ah, geez, you're slacking.
You're slacking.
I need four more.
Where are these ladies at? Come on, man.
Jesus.
Ben RP with a $10 chat. They want K, a.k.a. Heels Up Harris, a.k.a. Come Swallow Up Hold My Harris, M. Hoffa as president. Yes. She is the she's the gift inside the Trojan horse that is Corn Pop's arch nemesis.
Yes, I think you're right.
Oh, now they're downvoting. It's like, no, there's a bunch of dudes who are just like, oh, okay, I'll get him there. You a-holes.
I love okay, you guys.
We love you guys. No homo. Kevin DeLeo, one of our subscribe stars. Pop and Blake should do a redonkulous version of Blade Runner's Tears of the Rain, then call it Drinking Whiskey in the Rain.
I've done that many times. I remember in my platoon, it's raining. It's cold. We're sitting around a fire, barely hanging on. And somebody pulls out this big thing of whiskey, and we just start passing it around.
Nice.
It's fucking awesome.
I'm going to jump back over here to Streamlabs just because, not the first one, but the second chat.
Okay.
80 has donated again. Fetal communism, it takes time. Also, the more of us than them, not for long if they can get the world population eager and desperate for injections, which they're doing a very good job of doing. I'm not saying that's what's happening. Just if I was the bad guy, that would be my plan.
Yeah, but listen, if they don't inject enough people, and then they start actually dying and getting sick from this, that is going to be another thing that pushes the masses to act.
Yes.
Because, you know, they're pushing shit that's killing people.
And it definitely is.
Oh, well, okay. You've had some people die from it. They have a genetic thing, and then they put it in there, and they get it triggers a rare blood disorder. And yeah. They die. That's proof. When they give you this vaccine, it is actually manipulating shit at a DNA level in your body.
I love that they actually have to come out and say, oh, it doesn't change your DNA, even though we have Zuckerberg on record saying that it does. He didn't realize he was on record, but that's the beauty of the internet.
Wasn't that Project Veritas that busted him out?
I do believe so.
I love those guys.
And now they're coming out with, you know, that they're doing their little, you know, Occupy Democrat memes saying it doesn't alter your DNA. That's impossible.
No, it's not.
My ass. We know that just the act of dumping your DNA in a road hooer is enough to keep it in her body forever. So don't tell me that it can't mod your DNA. If my bazooka juice can do it, a vaccine can do it.
Yeah.
The drinking straw. Donated. Power bottom, term used to describe a homosexual male who receives it bottom but is dominant instead of the top.
I don't want to, why are you telling me this? I don't need to know this. Stop putting like,
just because
it's a horrible facts. you're cramming this stuff in my ear holes and it's polluting my thinking meat.
This is the comment equivalent of a
flamethrower. I need to scrub out my brain pan.
That's the comment equivalent of a flamethrower.
That's horrid, man. Come on, stop doing that.
Rylos1, thank you for the $10 donation. Facebook employee donated. Zuck should watch some pop. Blake, you should show Popster George Carlin's clips on YouTube. That would be a nuke of the experience. Absolutely.
I've seen a lot of his stuff, but I mean, the guy was just such a genius.
Oh, yeah. I'm so glad that I got to see him live.
I could never, ever like talk at his level because I'm a grunt.
Grunt.
I mean, I'd speak at grunt level.
Yeah.
I could still convey the same shit.
I'm sure that you two could have carried on a conversation, though, because Carlin, as intelligent as he was, he was a veteran. He was in the Air Force.
Yeah, the Air Force.
I know.
I got a Denny's for a chow hall, they live in a Hilton, you know?
It's all in the songs. You know? I mean, you can tell that the Air Force is not out there with the same kind of intensity and training that the armies and the Marines are, you know,
well, the Marine,
even the Navy anchors away, you know,
like the Marines. I love those guys to death. I mean, I've probably converted 200 Marines into great soldiers, but they just treat their people poorly.
I know.
And their leadership is stupid.
I know. I'm just saying, like, it's all in the songs. You can tell that the Air Force is looked down on by the rest because of the songs. What is the Army's song?
I don't remember.
Halls of Montezuma to the Swords of Tripoli.
No,
that
that's Marines.
Okay. But then you have the Air Force. Off we go into the wild blue yonder. Off we go. What?
Yeah. But during World War II, they were called the Army Air Corps, and they took like 38,000 to 42,000 casualties, and almost all of them were dead.
Ugh.
I mean, you're in a bomber. The bomber goes down. There's what, like 16, 18 people on that plane.
I got to ask, though, how were you in the Army for 33 years and you don't know the fucking Army song?
It's Overhill, Overdale. It's from World War One.
Oh, now you know it. Okay.
I'm not going to sing a song. I don't sing shit.
I'm not saying. I'm not asking
men
you
don't
to sing,
man.
Men don't sing.
Men don't sing.
What?
I'm not doing it. Listen, I have already had like a bunch of foo-foo drinks tonight. If I'm singing, I'll wind up homo confirmed. I can't do that. I'm not going there.
It's not like you're dating chicks or anything. I mean, what do you have to lose? Besides your stash of boner pills.
You're such a dick. Next one.
Moving on. Gorilla Bear, not to be confused with Gorilla Glue, the newest hair sensation for stunning and brave people of color.
Those people are so stupid.
Flamethrower reminds me of the video game Postal. I smell chicken.
Now that Gorilla Glue is some serious shit.
Yes, it is.
I've glued some shit together, and I couldn't even pull it apart.
The fact that this chick put it in her hair, and now she has to have an agent.
Yeah.
My faith in humanity is rapidly spiraling uncontrollably into the shitter, I'm just saying.
No, literally, I glued two large pieces of wood together, and I realized I made a mistake, and I was trying to separate them.
Yeah.
I literally destroyed the wood to get them apart. And I'm like, ah, oh, God damn it. I had to start all over.
Destroyed the wood.
Ripping it apart, like the glue gripped so tightly that chunks of the wood ripped out.
Oh, okay.
Like literally, it
homo confirmed.
It ripped the wood. Oh yeah.
Yeah, you're tearing the wood apart. Yeah, I bet you are. Yeah, how was your date yesterday?
Fuck off.
Fuck off. Where's your drinking
you
straw?
You motherfucker!
Where's your drinking straw?
Man, you stop! Stop! Why do this? You know I'm missing that filter. I get these horrible images.
Yeah, filters are for coffee. Dwayne Hicks, $5. Keep benching MGTOW in your thoughts and prayers, gents. He just got a negative PET scan results on his cancer status. He's a fighter, former Army.
Oh, shit. Okay.
All right, yeah. Well, keep him in your thoughts and prayers, gentlemen. Drape Toman, $5 chat. Thanks, gentlemen. The sheep can't accept the truth. Check out the interview with Yuri Bezmenov. I will save that one and Google it later. Well, not Google it. I duck-duck-go it because...
Duck-duck-go it.
Fuck Google, that's why. Dinoside 13, I'm moving to a 2A country, or to a county in northern Wisconsin and homeschooling my future kids.
Good.
It's cool, though. My girlfriend is a fan of the show, likes the camping gear, and hates Fleminists. Maybe I should put a ring on it?
Watch the string along episode. You can string it up for 13 to 15 years before you have to trade it in.
Yeah.
You know, ring bluff one, get ring bluff two.
The promise ring, right?
Yeah. Shut up. You know, the dog, you know, move
you know,
in.
Just the fact that you brought up a promise ring in that episode, I think that's almost suspicious.
That's ring bluff one, man. That's ring bluff one.
I gotta get her.
That'll buy you. That can buy you 1 to 3 years.
1 to 3 years. I just think it's hilarious. You know, I'm gonna go take you to get your ring size. Oh, okay. Are you gonna? No, it's a promise ring, baby. Oh, I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
I don't care. I don't care. I'm just saying.
Gorilla Glue toothpaste. Oh, that'd be a terrible idea.
Yeah, my ex-wife.
But you know what?
My ex-wife could use that.
Yeah, you said you sneak that into a Nagger's toothpaste, and then you will have what the Buddhists call inner peace, because she can't talk to you.
Yeah.
Glue her jaws together.
And for those of you who are
not
talking
blowing
about
you anymore anyway.
That right? word isn't referring to the bad N-word. It's to women who've been married 3 years or more.
That's why I enunciated.
Okay. I'm just saying, you know, people are like, oh, my God, he said the N-word.
I don't say that word. Who am I, Joe Biden? Come on.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. So, yeah, good luck to you, Dinoside 13, Kuro Ninja. Pop and Blake, check the COVID-19 stats in India. Oh, yeah, we talked about that. Yeah.
It's not crushing India.
No. And, you want to talk about bad health conditions.
They have tuberculosis over there.
Yeah. There's probably a lot of diseases that we consider extinct in this country that are present over
speaking
there.
Of India, did you know that the little girls who wind up in orphanages, if they don't get adopted in a certain amount of time, they just disappear?
Oh?
Yeah. My attorney's daughter adopted two twin girls from India because she found out that was the deal. And she's like, oh, that's unacceptable. Yeah, that's bad.
Oh, now there's people like coming up with different different ideas for Gorilla Glue products. We got Gorilla Glue for yeast infections. We got Gorilla Glue motor oil for single moms. We got Gorilla Glue toilet paper. Oh.
You're mean. That's just mean, man.
That is the...
That's mean.
That's what do we say? Shit happens with that one. Like, whew.
Oh.
Outstanding. Facebook employee, you can't rely on China and India's numbers on COVID. They just don't register them. If you check on how Indian government works, you understand. Well, that is, there's definitely some truth to that because they are going full bore Feminist in India and it is getting bad.
Yeah, I've actually, we've received a couple emails from the craziness that goes on over there. It is insane.
Yeah, absolutely. Crusader Nate did the exact same chat as before. I don't know. He might have thought that I skipped over. I didn't skip you. I just do the Streamlabs first. Dinoside 13, $5. I'm in the only 2A sanctuary in southeastern Wisconsin. Where do I sign up for Pop's Prepper Group? Me and a few dudes will gladly sign up.
Well, send me your emails to redonkulous12@gmail.com.
Do we?
I will move you over to another email. And then put you on a mailing list.
Absolutely. Wrenches, throw that email in the chat for the dudes who want to join the prepper group or who just want to send us some articles to cover. Chris B. in Philly with a donation, $5. Thank you very much. Heavy Water Triad or Tread, $10. Is Bigfoot real?
I would say yes.
Yeah? I think so?
Yeah.
What are your feelings on the Loch Ness Monster?
I don't think so.
No.
No, I mean, who knows what's going on out there? I mean, there's all kinds of weird shit in this world.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the entire idea of, you remember that movie The Meg with Jason Statham and stuff? The idea of geothermal pockets at the below the surf, the bottom of the ocean.
Keeping it contained.
Yeah, keeping heat and stuff contained so the different kinds of creatures and stuff can live down there. Who the hell knows what's out there that we've never seen
that actually
could eat us alive?
They tagged like this great white shark. It was like 16 feet long. It had a GPS tracker on it, and, you know, it just disappeared. And they found the tracker because whatever disappeared the shark, shit it out, went to the surface, then the tracking tag washed up on a beach, and somebody found it and turned it in.
Holy shit. No, I never heard about that.
Yeah, a 16-foot great white shark got perished like that. I watched a YouTube video on it, and I was like, holy shit.
You're going to need a bigger ass
and then
shit out that turd.
They had a camera at the bottom of one of these drilling wells.
Yeah.
And like they show this huge shark roll by, and I'm like, it's insanely large.
Wow.
I don't even know what kind it was. I was like, holy shit. That shit scares the shit out of me.
Yeah. I don't know, are we allowed to say great white shark on YouTube anymore?
I mean, it is.
We're going to get banned.
It is an actual species.
Son of the page. Ah, oh, we're so screwed.
Polar bear, you know, stuff like that.
Can't say anything anymore on this damn platform. I'm amazed we get away with as much as we do.
To be honest, we're small fish. We're harmless for now.
For now. Gert Froby with a $5 chat. America is screwed. We are all meat now. Well,
yeah.
In Bill Gates' America, at least no one will eat us.
Yeah, we're all screwed, and, you know, we're all going to have to come together to unfuck the whole thing. And
unfuck it!
It's gonna take a big event to make that happen.
Yes, it will. Crusader Nate, Pop, I have looked at getting a ham radio license. From what I've seen, only a licensed person can be a proctor for testing future ham radio. I would be willing to get all broadcasting.
All right,
send us an email. Hook it up. We'll see with a donation. Thank you very much. Bryce Friday. Actually, a bouncer in a game bar is the flamethrower. Outstanding.
Wow.
Outstanding.
That is funny, man.
That is out. I love it. Gerd Froby, $5. My wife and I have been married for 31 years. It doesn't always go wrong. Yeah, like we've said before, if half of all marriages end in divorce, half of them at least stay together.
Yeah.
Doesn't make them happy.
No.
But it means that, you know, half of them stay together.
If he's been married for 31 years and he's still, and they're happy, blissfully married, he's probably one of the 2%.
Yeah.
Okay, that's, you know, you're not going to get that in your next life.
In the butt.
Your next life, you're not getting that. That's like, you get that like once every 15 or 16 lifetimes.
Yeah.
You're not getting that again.
Nah. Jimmy Bones with a donation. No more giving thanks to the patron saint of the porcelain throne, Ralph, for me ever again. Also, how about that Capitol Police chief talking about the armed militias and that nonsense?
Okay, well, listen, the militias have always existed here in the United States.
It's part of the Constitution.
It is part of the Constitution. And then the states form the National Guard that are supposed to be the militia. In reality, they're just another branch of the federal government.
Just the fact that the left is trying to demonize that now shows you exactly where their head is in this game.
Well, I mean, I'm going to be honest. If you have enough militias and things go south, you know, that could be really bad for the people who are like running the show.
Yeah. Because
I mean, think about it. We've been at war now for 20 years.
Yeah.
That's a lot of people who have cycled out of combat zones that know exactly how to do it. And most of them, if they're frontline fighters, they don't even fear death anymore.
Yeah.
That's scary.
It is very scary.
It is. And if they get motivated, it's going to be a problem.
It'll be a very big
problem. I hope it doesn't happen. I hope we all could do a kumbaya and we can get beyond all this craziness. But as a betting man, I'm not putting my money in that pile.
Agreed. All right. Shall we move on?
Yes.
To the topic of the night. Well, one of the big topics of the night.
What's the other one?
Of course, this came about after the insurrection on January 6th. This was the first mention of it. We're going over here to Breitbart.
Yep.
Biden orders review of domestic violent extremism threat. But, I mean, of course, you know, if there's any sort of domestic, you know, violent threat, you want to have it addressed, right? But then you go down and then you hear from none other than Schiff for Brains, the Democratic chair of the House Intelligence Committee. How he still has that job after literally committing treason, I have no idea, said it was critical that the Biden administration appear to be prioritizing the threat of domestic extremism, in particular, far-right, white supreme pizza extremism, nurtured on online platforms, has become one of the most dangerous threats to our nation.
Yep.
So you can see exactly where their heads are. They're not actually looking to address the real problem.
Listen, we had almost entire 2020 engulfed in riots. People were attacking federal buildings, seizing blocks, doing all kinds of burning down whole swaths of cities.
Yep. But we're not going to talk
about that. And they're not labeling them insurrectionists. But like the whole Capitol thing, we saw the footage of the cops moving aside. They walk in all, you know, lackadaisical. And yes, there was some craziness that took place. I mean, a couple windows were busted.
Yeah,
somebody stole a laptop, may or may not have wound up in the Trump administrative's hands. But you know, in the grand scheme of things, it was like a rude interruption.
Yeah. It just really, I mean, how many billions of dollars, over $2 billion in damage over the last 9-10 months? And
it's literally more damage.
Dozens of murders, and not people who were protesting. So that's one of the big key differences here. When you're talking about what happened on January 6th versus the fiery but peaceful protests that have been taking place, the dozens of people who have been killed are cops, people who just happen to be going by. Sakoria Turner, 8-year-old girl sitting in the back seat of a car that happened to be pulling a U-turn in a parking lot across the street from a Wendy's in Atlanta that had been burned down the night before.
Yeah.
Okay. Innocent people being killed by these fiery but peaceful protesters. When you look at the Capitol riot,
listen.
4 people killed, right?
Well, no, listen. More people have been killed than that. It's just a lot of them have been called like. What about all the shootings in Chicago and all the gang violence and all the bullshit that's been taking place when the police have been weakened?
Yeah.
You know, you can throw those deaths in there, too.
Yes. Yeah, there's definitely a lot of that going on.
Somebody needs to put together a list of all of those deaths, and we can put it on the doorstep of those who are responsible for it, Antifa and BLM.
Yeah, it really is hilarious just how much the media wants you to believe they care about human life, about all this stuff, about...
They just care about ratings, man.
Yeah, all they do is care about ratings.
Well, one, they care about ratings, and two, they're pushing an agenda.
Yes, and it does not seem...
They don't work for us anymore.
No, they don't work for us.
They don't even work with us.
No. It's pathetic.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, I'm getting spun up. Let's move on to the next one. This is the making me angry.
This is the last subject of the night, dude. We're going to be talking about this for a bit.
All right. I'm getting spun up, man. This is really pissing
me off. That article was published January 24th. You can already see where this is going. If what Trump said is inciting violence, then, you know, the whole idea of looking for a far right threat or what have you. It could be anything. According to the left now, you're far right if you're to the right of Karl Marx. That's how bad it's gotten.
Yep.
So we're going to head over here to Rumble. Biden plans to issue a new domestic terrorism law as a possible way to target American citizens.
Lawmakers may be looking to use the controversial 2001 Patriot Act against people arrested at the January 6th Capitol Hill breach.
Shocker.
On America's Shane Althaus has more.
Federal prosecutors are claiming two members of the Proud Boys, Ethan Nordine and Dominic Pizzola, could be charged with crimes of terrorism following their involvement at the January 6th Capitol riot. While terrorism is only a federal offense if it is committed by or on behalf of a foreign actor, domestic terrorism is not a federal offense. However, prosecutors argue the label of terrorism could help judges enact lengthier sentences on the two Proud Boys. According to the ACLU, current law under the 2001 Patriot Act gives the government extensive authority to seize the assets of people they designate as domestic terrorists without trial. The 2001 anti-terrorism law gives the government the ability to use the secret FISA courts to get warrants. These warrants are then used by the NSA to tap into private emails and phone calls of suspected terrorists.
So you can see where this is going.
Yep.
This began with a so-called, you know, with the terrorist threat. You know, the U.S. absolutely had nothing to do with what happened on, you know, 9/11. You know, just like Ilhan Omar says, some people did something, right?
Uh-huh.
So they had nothing to do with it. It wasn't just a smokescreen and an excuse for our own government to spy on its own people, which we know now is exactly what it was. And now they're doing it again, and they're just going to ramp it up to 11.
Yeah. And you know what? It's unwarranted.
Yes.
Like this whole the whole Patriot Act thing, they need to repeal all that bullshit and the FISA court crap. It's already been abused. And nobody's been held accountable for the abuse of the FISA court. So just get rid of it. It doesn't need to be there. It's bullshit.
No, it's a complete
It's just another
waste.
Judge that you can't sue for violating your constitutional rights.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's all it is.
And the really funny thing is that, you know, they've actually got a lot of people in this country convinced that the far right is this huge movement that's...
It's not.
You know, it's coming for them. You know, hide your kids, hide your wife, hide your husbands, because they power bottom and everybody up in here. But it's all fake. Because they're literally reclassifying crimes that are committed by the far left as far-right extremism.
Yeah,
we did a whole
video
on
that, ripping it apart.
If you guys did not see the far-right boogeyman, check that one out. I think it got algorithmically throttled into oblivion on YouTube because almost no one watched it. But definitely check that one out because you will be... Some of you won't be shocked, but you'll be surprised at the length... That they're going to try to make this look like a legitimate threat.
Like literally, they're lying. It's all propaganda, man. It's all bullshit.
Yes. And now, of course, this is going even beyond. This is going beyond just typical citizens. Now we have to, of course. We're extending this into the military even further than preventing, you know, white supreme pizzas from being there at the inauguration. Pentagon report warns of threat from white supreme pizzas inside the military. And second paragraph in, they load the ammunition so that they can attempt to blame this on Trump. The report was drafted by the Trump administration last year before the January 6th riot at the Capitol. Well, at least they call it a riot and not an insurrection. I suppose that's something. And was sent to Congress last October, but never made public until now.
I don't believe that at all.
I don't believe it either. Just like I don't believe the...
I don't believe anything the media says.
Well, I don't believe the media, and you can't even believe the Pentagon. Because you remember, after we did Purple Heart's Final Beat, somebody tried to debunk it by sending us Pentagon stats about marriage in the military.
It was somebody inside the Pentagon. And the marriage stats that they sent us was like from Leave It to Beaverland.
Oh, yeah. It's like only 5 to 10% of military couples actually get divorced. Like, get out of here. Who do you tell me?
I know. Like, the general population, it's like at that time was 52%.
Oh, my God.
So you're telling me, like, in the military, people are getting divorced at 10% less than the general population? That's a blatant lie that they sent us.
Oh, it's complete fabrication.
Ah, man. I laughed him off the stage. I remember I called the lady, too, and I'm like, you're out of your goddamn mind. You know this is a flat-out lie.
Where would they even get that from?
I have no idea.
I mean, every military dude, chick, doesn't matter, I've ever talked to, they all have the same vernacular when it comes to divorce and marriage in the military. They all know it's like wiping your ass. It's every day. It's that common.
Like, in my 30-some-odd years of military, I know 3 people who are still married today.
That's it.
That I knew when I, you know, from the beginning. 3 out of thousands upon thousands of people. And some of these dumbasses get married like 2 and 3 times in the service.
Ugh.
Look, I understand, you know, pussy's great, but come on. You know, one and done.
One and done.
Yeah, like, hey, you know, maybe I'll give it a go. You do it, doesn't work out, don't do it again. Because it's a sucker bet.
It's very much a sucker bet, yeah. Oh, my gosh. It's just that they keep pushing this fake bullshit. I just don't understand it. And because it's pushed by the lamestream media, people buy it with their monopoly money that's rapidly losing its value.
Yeah, people, you know, listen, a lot of people are weak. They don't critically think, and they literally stand in front of the screen and they believe whatever they're told. Those are the people that are going to, you know, they're basically cannon fodder.
Yeah.
You know, they're the corpse cushions in the plane.
That still cracks me up, man, corpse cushions.
That's right. You sit right where the wings are, and you got a whole bunch of, you know, people in front of you to, like, basically cushion you as they die.
Corpse cushions.
Maybe you'll make it if you don't burn to death. You know, hey. The people in the back, you know, that back breaks off and, you know, falls apart and they get turned into hamburger.
Ooh.
People in the front get crushed. So, you know, if you're, like, somewhere in that midsection, maybe you'll survive. If it's not, you know, too much of a fire. But, you know, it is what it is.
It is what it is.
What are you looking up?
I'm trying to find that particular thing. I had so many sources for that far right boogeyman video that we did.
I know that I remember you bitching about it.
Well, I wasn't bitching about it. I was just kind of letting you know because I went through. I mean, I had there's 24 sources listed in the article.
Yep.
One of them basically debunks everything from the far from the top down, bottom up, and every shit layer in between. It's just hard to figure out because I archive everything because you never can tell when, you know, Google or Whackoffpedia, you know, or Amazon, you know, one of these server owners is just going to kick these sites off the internet for telling the truth because that's all it takes now to be considered hate speech is to tell the truth.
Yep.
So I archive everything just to be safe, which I guess that explains why I think it was about midway through last year they started gunning for the archive sites, saying that they were, you know, hosting dens of Nazis, people, you know, trying to come at you with facts, logic, and reason. Wee.
Yeah.
How dare you?
And Project Veritas did a short video about an insider at a conference call for one of those email marketing campaign places. I don't remember what it's called. And they're like flat out like, hey, look, you know, if you're a conservative, we're done doing business with you.
Yeah.
So it's, I mean, listen, like the conservatives are just gonna have to start their own internet. They're gonna have to do everything, and just maintain that, and they'll do their thing. We'll do ours. And never the two shall meet.
Never the two shall meet.
Nope.
Wee. Oh goodness. Well, we got some more chats here. Let me take a look. Inquisitor Jack 45 with a $5 donation. I'm an electrical engineer, so getting ham radio training is within my wheelhouse. Can you give any recommendations for night vision equipment? Hearing goggles and infra illuminator / laser is the way to go.
Okay. Well, if you're talking night vision goggles, you can pick up some ANPVS7s on eBay and for $2,400. Those are pretty good. The 14s, they're a little bit more expensive. They're a smaller unit. But I was actually eyeballing some of the thermal scopes out there, man. Those are really expensive. But, you know, if you get like a mid-range where you can, identify specific targets out to 700 meters with that thing, those are roughly about $3,500 to $4,200. Yeah. But those things are awesome. I was thinking of getting one to go down to Texas and shoot feral hogs at night. I think that'd be sweet.
Just shoot feral hogs.
Well, they're a nuisance down there. They're like killing
everybody. Oh, I know.
You know, you just like talk to the guy who owns the land. Like, hey, can I park my car here and shoot pigs? And
you
like,
can hang out with my brother-in-law. He does that shit.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I might have to go down there. Shoot us some pigs. Hate those bastards. I had a buddy of mine blew up a whole bunch of them.
But they taste so good.
He blew up a whole bunch of them with Tannerite.
Nice.
No, it was like 60 pounds of it. And he set it all up, and then the pigs would come in, and then the next day they're more and more. Like on the 10th or 11th day, there was just an insane amount of them just mowing down on the slot box around this explosive. he shot it, and they just disintegrated. It's like, I saw the video. I was like, wow. Wow. You can watch the shockwave in slow motion just like roll out there and like these pigs just fly away and they break apart in the air. I was like, wow, that's pretty spooky.
That is pretty spooky.
But hey, you know, it's his hobby. I mean, who am I to knock him?
Polska Bob with another $10. Blake, the big gay cruise ship just got upgraded. It's a big gay battleship.
It's got some good guns on it.
You suck my battleship.
I hated that game. God damn, this chair keeps giving out on me.
It's probably the operator.
No, man. I don't know what it's doing. I just, every once in a while, it just whoop, goes down. Whoop, whoop. Yeah, I don't know, man. We're in for some crazy times. And
yes,
I think the whole world is going to experience this. There's no safe place on the planet. Maybe some of those Slavic countries up there that have already destroyed all their businesses and they're basically mediocre, doing nothing, going nowhere. They might be okay. But, you know, they tanked the dollar, and then all of those countries that invested in American currency, it's worthless. You know, it's going to crush all kinds of people. It'll be chaos and turmoil galore.
Galore.
We're all doomed.
Doomed.
I hate saying that word.
It gets the hair on the back of your neck to stand up, doesn't it?
Yeah. What's the next one?
Domesta. 012, $5 donation. Where the Fleminist lie of men are always trying to take credit for the work of women come from? My only guess is it's projection. No matter what they say, they know they're only following the beaten paths of men that they are eternally dependent on.
Well, historically speaking, men build and maintain all of the civilizations. We also destroy them, too, but you know, that's a side note.
Hey, what are you gonna do?
But everything in your house, almost everything in the modern Western home is a product of nagging. Because back in the day, the man went out to work, the woman, she minded the home. And there's a lot of things that needed to be done, like wash clothes. That was like a whole day thing.
Yeah.
Wash dishes. You know, that took up a lot of time, especially if you're cooking three meals a day. The ice box, that had to become a refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
All of the stuff's invented by men. Okay? The air conditioner, the house is too hot. You know, a lot of the forced air furnaces and all of the crazy stuff that heats your home, to include the insulation put in the walls. If you go check the patents, it's all cooked up by a dude.
Cooked up by, yeah, most of it.
Yeah, most.
99% of it, 99.9.
I would say like 92% of it has been, you know, was invented by a dude.
Yeah, and then everything else that they try to push out there is saying, they're taking the credit from people of color, from women. It's always like somebody else invented it first, and then they invented something that improved on it. Or they invented a small component of the entire apparatus that they're trying to take credit for.
Yeah, that's actually rather common.
It's really pathetic that they try to twist it like that, though. And then they say, you know, we're still the party of science, right?
No, they've surrendered the party of science when they went to their metaphysical argument about the trans people.
Agreed.
Yeah, that's a religion, and religion and government are supposed to be separate.
Yes.
You're making laws about trans people based on a metaphysical argument. Listen, you just introduced religion into government by passing these crazy-ass laws.
Yep.
This is my opinion. What do I know?
Because we know what the science actually says.
I'm just an old grunt.
The science says that if you leave these kids alone when they have their little dysphoria moment, by the time they hit puberty, 80 to 90% of them are going to resolve it on their own.
Correct.
But if you force puberty blockers down their damn throat, because, of course, you know, when you're like, you know, 4 to 8 years old, you're totally capable of making life-changing decisions that are going to affect the rest of your natural born existence, shortened as it may be, because you're going to force puberty blockers and hormones into your body that are going to completely butt-fuck you into eternity and probably give you cancer of every different kind.
Yeah, down the road, if you're on a lot of that crazy stuff, it's going to catch up to you later. And if you start young, the consequences hit you younger.
Absolutely.
Like if you start smoking at 13 and you smoke every day, by the time you're in your like mid to late 30s, you're in the lung cancer window.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, man. But I did find that article that I wanted to share with you guys. I'm going to throw it in the chat for you, but we're going to take a look at it here first. How the Left Creates Fake Studies to Fabricate Right-Wing Terrorism. This was a big source that we used in the far-right boogeyman episode. Basically, every study you have ever read that says far-right terrorism is the big problem in the country, it's a lie. It's a flat-out lie. All of the studies are fake. They use incidents as a key metric. Written in the methodology, we coded threats of violence as attacks rather than plots, even if the threat turned out to be a hoax. So basically, even though Jussie Smollett staged his own attack, it will still be considered a far-right attack in the statistics, even though it never happened.
And it's completely fabricated.
It's completely fabricated, but they will still count it. Same thing with Bubba Wallace and his BS. Or any of the kids who, you know, paint the N-word on the door of their, you know, dorm room.
Or things like that. Or the bag of poop.
Yes. Even if it's completely fake, they are still going to count it. Manipulating the definitions. Each study is careful about the definitions. The CIR redefines right-wing teriyakiism as militia movements, as well as white supreme pizza, anti-government, anti-Muslim, anti-immigrant, anti-abortion extremists, including radical Christians. Oh, goodness gracious. And then the CSIS casts it even wider for things like incels, misogyny, hatred based on sexuality, gender identity, and or opposition to certain policies such as abortion. You just keep going on down the lists. Lone wolves, despite the fact, even if, you know, a teriyakiist organization claims credit for it, or they just flat out admit, I did this because of
X,
Y, Z, what have you. Still not counted. The Washington Mall shooter, Arkan Seton, killed 5 people. Lone wolf, not counted. Esteban Santiago killed 5 people at an airport and told that he specifically told the FBI he carried it out on behalf of ISIS. Lone wolf, not counted. Beltway snipers, not counted. Stabbing of two men in a mall in Minnesota, pleading guilty to an ISIS-inspired plot to commit a mass murder in Texas, not counted. And then just inconsistent application of the rules. I will throw a link to this in the chat for you guys so you can check it out.
Tear it apart, man. You'd read the stuff.
It really is just incredible, the shit that the lamestream media and these so-called bipartisan think tanks think they can get away with some fancy wording and legalese.
Yep. It's propaganda.
It is.
They're just pushing a narrative. It's empty. It's so empty, it's insane.
It is extremely empty. Emptier than your ex-wife's head.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
Yeah.
Because about 3 feet further south is quite full. On the regular.
Yeah. Some crazy ass shit right there.
Yes. 3G Craftsman. I managed a 16-year string along, and I have the scars to prove it.
Amen to you, man. Amen. 16 years. That's pretty good.
That's a new record.
Yeah.
That's a good record right there. Jaffo on the Bound. Amendment 1 Preparedness.com makes tactical ham radios out of ammo cans. Pass the word.
Send us the link.
He did.
Okay. Well, send it to our email, because
You're going to forget.
I'll forget it.
You forget it. Yeah, he's right. Ridiculous12@gmail.com. CJ with a donation. Just can't stop hog slaying, can you?
No.
No. Because Pop loves lasagna more than he loves skinny bitches.
Listen, there's a lot to be said about cool points, man.
I agree.
If she don't bug me and she's got cool points, I can overlook a lot of shit.
Especially
if they could cook.
Yeah, there are hard nines and tens walking around out there. Very few tens. There's only
I've met one.
I've met maybe like five in my life that I would consider tens. But as soon as they open their mouth, that number starts to drop really quick. They're only tens for about the first 10 minutes. And then it radically starts to go downhill from there.
It's literally they open their mouth and it's an orchestra of teeth and fingernails on a chalkboard. It just makes your skin crawl.
It's like they open their mouth and
some of them have some of them have such bullshit expectations. Like, well, you're not doing that. Like, no, I'm not doing that. I guess this is gonna be over. Okay,
yeah.
Get out of here then.
I mean, if you're gonna open your mouth and sound like that, I might just have to put a dick in it. I'm just saying.
No, literally, I've told many a woman to get the hell away from me. I'm like, just get the hell away from me. Go find some other sucker.
Just get out of here. I don't want to see you. I want to hear from you. I don't know what's going on.
Literally, I'm just like, you need to find another sucker that's going to put up your bullshit because I'm done.
Dude, Doom Donuts has got more gay jokes. She opened her mouth, and I was so bored, I went for dudes. Blake's new gay novel.
Jesus Christ.
I am not gay. My boyfriend is, but I'm not gay. Channel 1-800-DUMB, New Zealand, $5. Love to Papa and Blakey. Shout to the boys. Computer keeps dying on live streams. WTF, we'll rewatch later. Hugs, you poo pants. XOX. Okay, now there's your homo suspicion points for the night right there.
Yeah, right there, right there.
Oh, goodness gracious.
What'd she say?
Damon Wolf MGTOW. Strong men build countries. Strong countries build weak men. Weak men destroy country, as the story is told over and over too many times.
That's exactly correct.
Yep. James Rankin, $5. Any thoughts on alternative technologies at a grassroots level to give the big middle finger to the globalist cult like cold fusion?
Okay, well, I actually have a hand in a new, very efficient generator design that we're going to try to bring forward. Like, you know, right now, if you have a generator to heat to power your house, you got to put gas in it like 3 or 4 times a day. The one we're trying to work on, you put gas in it like every other day, every 2 days.
Yeah, and just don't let that chick from the first video drive off with it, because she'll take the whole fucking hose and nozzle with her while you're trying to fill that generator. No, don't do it.
Yeah, like there's a listen. One of my buddies, he's watches a lot of the streams. Pat, you want to call him Pat Wax Daddy?
Oh, Pat Wax Daddy. He's not here tonight.
No, he's the old Lurse guy. Dude's a fucking genius. He's always been a creative genius. Just insane. Well, geniuses, they like to hang out. And he's got a network of little, you know, turbo geniuses. And this one dude is working on this shit. He's like, yeah, that's fucking good stuff. So I used to be an investment banker. I'm going to look at the stuff. From what I've seen so far, it's not bad. I got to see the component list, what it requires, and where these components come from, because that's going to determine if we can do anything with it or not at this day, at this stage in the game.
Gotcha. Yeah, I mean, there's so many different technologies out there that exist that would make everybody's life a hell of a lot easier. That would make the whole green energy movement a lot easier and a lot more cost-effective for the average person. Problem is, a lot of the patents for these things get bought up and destroyed. Or
they don't release them.
It's not even that. The guys who refuse to sell wind up committing suicide with 3 bullets to the back of the head or just flat-out disappeared, things like that.
Well, I'm telling you, if I ran the show, I'd go to the patent office, I'd release all that shit, and I'm like, hey, so first come, first serve. If you can do anything with this patent, have at it.
Mm-hmm.
And people can whine and cry all they want. Sorry.
Fuck them.
There needs to be progress to move forward.
I concur. Console Peasant Rescue. Radical Christians? So they have skateboards? Oh, the bacon is back, 223. Finish nodding, Nick August's chat. What'd I miss? You guys have to watch it.
You gotta watch it, man. Missed a whole lot.
It was good times. We're talking about the Yahoo stimulus and Beijing Biden's excuse for wiretapping the entire country because he wants to fight white supreme pizza.
Yep.
Among the population and the military, never mind the fact that the radical left has been completely destroying small businesses, property, government property. I love how, like, what's his name? Merrick Garland, whatever the fuck his name is, the guy that didn't get confirmed as a Supreme Court justice, and now Biden wants to try to shoehorn him in there as the attorney general. Dude can't string 3 fucking words together without looking like his face is going to explode. He makes Biden look eloquent. He's that bad.
Wow.
And he has no answers for anything.
None of them do.
He has no answers for anything at all.
Listen, if what you're doing is based in fact, logic, reason, and is true, you can answer everything.
Exactly.
If everything is under some shadow of suspicion, or it's a narrative, or it's completely fabricated,
we'll have to circle back.
Yeah,
right?
Circle back. You can't answer them.
That's basically what he said. Somebody asked him, like, you know, if this is a problem, you know, the white supreme pizza and what happened in the Capitol on January 6th, if this is a problem, what do you call, like, literal destruction of government property? You know, the police department in Minneapolis, the many government buildings that, you know, had got Molotov cocktailed in Portland and Seattle. What do you call that?
People were blinded.
Well, you know, I really didn't, I don't have an answer for that.
They were throwing explosives and people were blinded.
If that guy's our new attorney general, I'd rather fucking staple gun my ball sack to the ceiling.
Yeah, we're fucked. We are fucked.
And not in a good way. And not even in a power bottom kind of way. Not even in a power bottom and bring your drinking straw and then have a Neapolitan milkshake kind of way.
Yeah, we're
fucked.
It's
worse than all that.
It's bad. It's going to be bad.
This is the kind of fucked that everyone is going to feel.
Yes.
Right on down the line.
It's going to be ugly.
Where was I? Michael Davis, $4.99. Hey, Pop, I sing BNDX.
Good for you.
According to Pop, you're not a man. Men don't sing.
I'm not singing shit. The only thing I ever sang in my life was Cadence.
Do it.
No.
Do it.
I'm not doing it.
Do it. You do it when we're prepping for filming.
I'm not doing it in front of the camera.
Do it.
No. I refuse.
Fag.
I'm being a puss.
Yes, you are. As long as you admit it.
All right.
But you are what you eat, right?
Yeah, actually.
Dick.
Oh, touche. Oh, that's a good one. That's a good burn, man.
James P., $25. Thank you very much. You're a national treasure. Strength and courage.
Thank you. I'm just being myself. I'm not trying to do anything special. I'm just a dude like anyone else.
And apparently he don't sing.
Listen, all I've ever done to make myself stand away from the pack is I took a step forward to volunteer.
And then, your sister, your brother, your uncle, the quickest, the
and then when you know shit went fucking south, I got on my feet. I'm not doing it.
Do it.
No.
Sing it, foo foo pop.
I'm not doing it.
Do it. Mm-mm. The law, the judge, the book of the baker. Come on.
No.
Do it.
No.
Do it.
No.
Do it.
No.
Do it.
No.
You enjoy the taste, smell, and feel of penis.
I'm not doing it, man. Stop it. Oh man.
A hole.
Yeah, I know. I know. What are you gonna do?
Like I said, you are what you eat.
Oh, dude, I'm not the captain of the gay cruise, man.
No, you're the guy that scrubs the poop deck.
Oh, damn, you are on fire. Is it the wine?
It's the wine.
Dude, that was like an 8 out of 10 burn. It was a very quick comeback. It was a touche burn. It goes right to the heart of the matter. You're playing upon my fear of being a homo. I mean, it's an 8 out of 10.
You have a fear.
I don't want to be homo confirmed because, listen, I drink all these foo-foo drinks. You know, it is what it is. I'm being honest here. I've done the whole homo suspicion points. It's Gaydar using math. You know how it works.
I know. It's just, it's really funny to me.
Listen, my NCOs used to laugh their asses off because, like, I won't hold a purse.
I know. We still have to do that skit.
Like, one of my NCOs, we're at a formal. His wife comes in, hands him her purse. He's holding on to it. I walk right up to him. I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, what? Why are you holding that purse? What do you mean? I go, you know that's two homo suspicion points to get caught holding a purse. You can guard a purse or you can camouflage it, but you can't be seen openly holding a purse. And like I had a commander had one of those man bag things.
Oh, the merce.
It was like a briefcase.
It's a satchel.
That's what he called
it's
it.
A
I'm
satchel.
I'm like
Indiana Jones carries a satchel.
I'm like, sir, is there a gun in that satchel? No. Then that's two homo suspicion points.
Put it down.
That's a purse. I'm going to have to homo confirm you here until you fix this.
Damn it. You mean my man's bag?
I used to mess with him. And he was like a city manager for a city in New York. He was a great guy. That was hilarious. I used to fuck with him mercilessly.
you mercilessly fucked with the merce guy.
Yeah, I did. I remember his computer was like dying and he was getting all pissed off. I'm like, what's going on? This goddamn computer, I was only 6 months old. I'm like, oh, okay.
And they always try to justify, you know, carrying the man purse around. Oh, it's really convenient. It holds all of my stuff. You know,
keep a gun in it.
It holds my gun. It holds my notebooks, your makeup.
No. If you have a gun in there, then it's good.
It's good.
You can carry a gun in the man purse.
Okay, so
it
that's just
if yeah, it negates it if you have a gun in there.
It negates it, okay, all right.
If you don't have a gun in there, I'm going to have to give you two homeless points.
What if you have multiple guns in there?
Well, then you're good.
Then you're good. Well, does that, like...
Well, it all depends.
Does it go back the other way?
Like, if it was me, and I was drinking foo-foo drinks, which is two homeless suspicion points, and I had a man bag with two guns in it, and I chased it with whiskey, then I would be at a... You know, I'd be good. I'd be well below the homo confirm line.
So this is my plan for your coming birthday.
Oh my god.
Okay, I'm gonna get you a foo foo drink kit. Okay, and I'm gonna put like a gun in like a Hello Kitty bag where Hello Kitty is like slurping on some doggy sausage with a jar of peanut butter and a power bottom and a drinking straw. I'm gonna have like a whole little pouch just for the drinking straws. But because there's a gun in there. It's all good, and I expect you to carry it in public, like the good little bitch that you are.
That's not going to happen, man. Sorry.
Oh, it's going to happen.
I have my limits.
It's going to happen.
But listen, we could probably do a good half a dozen really good comedy skits on the homo submission points. Because it's Gaydar using math. We should make that app.
There should be an app. Yeah, somebody needs to help us. Anybody out there who knows how to like build apps for, you know, Android, iOS, whatever.
Yeah, and it could be just something that you sell for 50 cents. It's like a fun thing you do at the bar with your friends to figure who's homo confirmed. It'd be hilarious. There's a lot of people who would hate me for it, but I really don't care.
Oh, man. You just leave it in comments on all the alphabet community threads on the internet. People are like, oh, my God, this is the motherfucker.
But the thing, really funny? It's like you come up and you add up the dude, and it shows the whole worksheet, and then at the bottom it says homework confirmed. You can email it to his friends on Facebook, so they all know he's a homo.
They all know he's...
Well, he's homo confirmed. So, I mean, the math
I know.
Proves it.
It would have to be one of those face tracking apps. You know, like you take a picture of the dude when you're done with his quiz, and then if he's super duper homo confirmed, it like, you know, it puts the two hands in there. More cock!
We need to get that ringtone. I like to put together some ringtone packages because there's a whole lot of sound effects that are pretty ass.
Oh, yeah. I actually made one for my Jewish friend, you know, the one whose dad got sent all the dicks in the mail.
Uh-huh. Did you send what happened to the gonorrhea ringtone?
It's still there.
Where's it at?
It's available on the website.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you guys want a gonorrhea ringtone for your phones, go to redonkulous.com. It's on the downloads page. You can download it, add it to your phones. Yeah.
Free of charge.
Free of charge. I did make one for my Jewish friend where you say, L'chaim, bitch.
That's a good one.
I liked that one.
Yeah.
You got something for your Jewish friends over there. Orthodox or not.
I don't care.
Like my friend is like the worst Jew in the world. You know, she went on like a mission trip to Israel, and the first thing that she had when she came back, bacon cheeseburger.
Hey, you know, listen, like in Northern Oak Park and parts of Berkeley, there's a whole bunch of those like really, really religious Jewish individuals. They wear, they have the whole garb and everything.
Oh yeah, there's a big synagogue over there that I've shot at a few times.
They don't bug me. I mean,
nah.
I mean, they kind of annoy me when you hit them with your car, but. It's a lot of paperwork and hassle.
It's a lot of paperwork,
stuff.
And you got to track down the little hat when it flies off in the wind.
People
cry. It's like that last chase scene in The Last Crusade.
Yeah, you know, I don't like that.
Yeah,
it's a bummer.
Yeah, and it doesn't hold in blood the way that a fedora does.
No.
No.
No, definitely not.
No, really not. No. Mike, maybe clean your glasses with it.
I've seen that before, actually. Yeah. Oh, here's a funny thing. When I was in middle school, this guy he wore the yarmulke everywhere he went. And we're in the hall, and these three individuals of African descent were really screwing with them hard. And I didn't know this. His father was a professional boxer.
Oh.
And taught him how to fight. And he tuned these guys up like it was nobody's business.
Boom.
I was like, I'm like, you need to teach me how to do that because I want that power. He's not a big guy. He just put his hands up and like, oh, you're going to fight me, white boy? Uppercut, hook, right hand on the ground. Gut,
wow.
Hook. I mean, it's like six or seven punches. It took like 3 seconds. And then all the teachers come running out. Oh, my God. Oh, and they broke it all up. And I was just like, wow.
That was always my policy whenever I got into fights. It was just like, all right, are we going to do this? All right, fine. But, you know, I'm kind of hungry. I need to get home. So let's just do this. Come on. Ended quickly.
Yes.
You know, I was never one for humiliating anybody. Because ending a fight quickly that's already kind of implied.
Mm.
So, when I first moved into Troy and I was the new kid, you know, you always got to make fun of the new kid, right? You know, I'm trying to walk home and this guy's like, okay.
Let's do this.
I put my meat pumps up and all of a sudden he makes a classic mistake. Like, dude had no training at all. He just goes for the lunge. And I literally took one step to the side, stuck my foot out, and then just chopped him in the back of the neck as he went by, and he just fell face first onto the pavement. I picked him up. I'm like, you all right? You done fucking around?
Are we done now?
All right, we're good. All right.
I'll see you later.
All right. Clean that up. You got a little something. You got a little something right there.
Yeah. Go home. Well, I was – and the thing is I think he was so effective is they were so surprised that he had that level of skill and power.
Oh, yeah.
It just totally caught him by surprise. The look on their face was priceless.
Yeah, you can even the scales in a fight real quick with just, you know, training, skill, and like I said, that well-placed power. I mean, you ever see the movie The Rundown? Mm-hmm. It was like the first one that The Rock did with Stifler. in the day, and The Rock, you know, gets his ass handed to him by like three dudes who are all smaller than him, but they know exactly how to fucking hit him and knock his ass down. I always loved that fight. They're like swinging on vines and shit like little monkeys.
It took it. I didn't reach that level of ability until I was in my early 20s.
Yeah,
he had it in like seventh grade.
Sweet.
If he would have, I never saw him in the professional ranks, but I'm sure if he would have decided to fight pro, he would have made a lot of money.
Oh, I bet.
Because there's a lot of people come out watch the white Jew beat people up. I'm just saying.
Nice.
I'm like, they would market the shit out of that. He would, like, you know, hell.
I like it.
All right, let's move on.
All right, let's move on here. We're going to wrap up the Super Chats here and call it a night. Let's see. Jimmy Bones, when a 10 opens her mouth and she drops to a 5, give her a ball gag and get your 7 to 10 minutes of fun and call her an Uber. I concur.
Well, yeah, you better hurry up because in today's day and age, she'll wind up with a repay charge.
Yeah.
And you can go to jail.
Make sure you give her a fake name. Hey, Ken Adams, how you doing?
I've done that before.
It's a good call.
Yeah.
80 has donated $1. New AG is not terrorism if it happens at night, so the courthouse assault was fine. If that's a real quote, holy smoking Joe Frazier.
That's such bullshit.
Jail. Here we go. One man's way with a $10 donation. Pop's military stories and Blake's Stewie impression carry the show. Just saying.
The military stories.
I love the military stories.
People love those, man.
Because they're funny. And they're unique. You're not going to hear these stories anywhere else.
No. And you know what? There's probably hundreds more that I've forgotten over the years. That maybe someday I'll be reminded of them.
Yeah, you know, it's the brain damage. Bacon! 223, he makes Biden look eloquent for the winning. Merritt Garland is the antidote to intelligence. CJ, $5. Just look at Gorilla Glass used in the first touchscreens. Developed in the 60s, not used until the late 90s, I think. Way too much underused tech.
I would have to say yeah.
Yeah, without a doubt.
There's probably a lot of shit out there that we could have used and we could still use that's just laying on a shelf somewhere.
Okay, you're going to have to do the cadence now.
No, I'm not doing it.
Yes, you are. You want to know why?
Why?
One Man's Way donated $100 and says, Semper Fi. Can I get a cadence? So if you don't do it, you're kind of a turbo dick, and you are what you eat. Just do it once. Come on.
All right. Now, first of all, anyone who's a good NCO makes up their own goddamn cadence.
Yes.
And I've won awards calling cadence in the Army. So one of them I used to do was just a basic cadence. You know, I'd run through a series, and then there would be some interaction with the soldiers, but you'd be like, you know, so if you left, you left, you left, right, left. Your mother was home when you left. Your father was home when you left. The judge was home when you left. Your mother was home when you left. The police were home when you left, and that's the reason you left. Your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, the lodge, the judge, the butcher, the baker, the candlestick maker, they all were home when you left. And then you go through the sound off. Count Kingsley, kind, and all that horse shit.
It sounds like the chick he left back home was a sleut.
Sleut, yeah.
Yeah,
in fact,
the law, the judge, the booker, the baker, the candlestick makers. Oh man, yeah, they all got in there, man.
Mm-hmm. And I remember
that kid is not yours.
At the Thanksgiving parade in Detroit, you know, I marched a company of guys and called Canes for like the whole thing.
Nice. One Man's Way, thank you for that. You finally got him to open his suckhole and do a cadence. Bacon again, 223. Sing White Supreme Pizza for the gay crew.
White Supreme Pizza.
No.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I'm sure he had nothing to do with it. Mehmed, too, with a $9.99 donation. I'm a Navy civilian and a Guard soldier. A Navy announced they're going to force us to reaffirm our oaths. We were talking about this on Tuesday. Uh-huh. I refuse because oaths are given freely, not under force or coercion. A forced oath is not an oath.
You're absolutely correct.
Amen.
It's called under duress.
Exactly. Like, if somebody is pointing a gun to your head, you know, well, let's say, you know, shotgun wedding.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the literal, you know, interpretation of a shotgun wedding is you knock up a woman, her dad holds the shotgun to your head and makes you sign the marriage license so that you can do the right thing, right? That is not a valid marriage contract because you signed it under direct threat or coercion. Okay, it's the same thing with this bullshit oaths.
Well, the thing is what they'll do, and the Army does this, you'll show up to do the oath, there'll be a sign-in. You have to sign your name. All you got to do is next to your name, you put the initials U period D period, which means under duress.
Yeah, absolutely.
Administrative violence 101.
Administrative violence. It's going to be a whole webinar. Stay tuned. And while I'm out of town, because I think you guys should know, for the next 2 weeks, I'm going to be visiting family in Texas. While I'm there, obviously, can't film here. But we have shot Ride and Roast ahead of time, and we are still going to be streaming Tuesday and Thursday nights while I'm in Texas. While I'm there, I am also going to be working on the audiobooks for Jericho Files. So going to start releasing those chapter by chapter. I don't know if we're going to release them to everyone or just for Patreon and Subscribestar to start with. I don't know. I'm going to let Pop make that call.
We'll have to work that out.
We're going to work it out.
But
it's going to be good times because I get to read a whole bunch of Gore Ornpe.
Yeah, the books are getting 5-star ratings.
That's awesome.
Like 100% 5-star ratings.
I hope it stays that way.
Yeah, me too.
Well, once these chicks, like the 14 chicks who download our, you know, downvote our stuff, find out that you write books, it's going to be game over.
And I'll just write more books.
Just write more books. Oh, this is interesting. Not this one, the next one. Well, this one's two. CJ, $2. Oversized concealed carry holster, maybe? As far as like man purse, I'm guessing. Ascension! You ever fart so insanely hard that people in the room asked what's burning?
I've had some bad ones, and people are like, you better check and see
Holy
if you leak.
Shit. I've farted and almost gotten divorced. Gotta go sleep on the couch.
That's bad.
Inquisitor Jack donated. I've been reading book two of Jericho Files. It's pretty great. Safe travels, Blake. Thank you very much. I'm going to be driving the whole way, 20 hours, stopping halfway through in Missouri.
You guys, if you read the books, let me know if you like the kill scenes.
The kills.
The fight and kill scenes.
Yeah. Ascension again. Happened to me today. Some mistook me as an army grunt.
Hey.
Michael Pelletier says Ascension needs to see a doctor. I would agree with that. If they're asking what's burning instead of what's that smell, you got a problem. Maybe too much Del Taco. Perhaps.
You need to get checked.
Yeah, you need to get checked. And hopefully not by somebody Chinese who just wants to know whether or not you have the coof. I couldn't feel my lower half for 10 minutes. I had to check and see if I had my nuts. It's a good chance they weren't there. I'll email you soon, Pop and Blake. I got to meet you guys. It is foretold to happen.
Okay.
Hey, you know.
I'm cool with it.
We're going to be in Vegas last weekend of March. If you're out that
way. Is it the last weekend? I thought it was second to last.
Last weekend in March. March 26th through the 28th. We're going to be in Vegas.
Okay.
Good stuff. And the bacon again. Under duress is how some women get out of prenups. Ooh.
They do.
Yeah, that's right.
They do.
Oh, I was under duress.
He said he wouldn't marry me if I didn't sign it.
That's not duress. That's a fact.
Yeah. Well, there's some judges like, well, that's messed up.
Son of a bitch.
You need to. She has a vagina, so you have to pay for that for the rest of your life. Man, what the fuck?
Doom Donuts is like, farted and almost got divorced. Yeah. Yeah, Hungry Howie's Pizza and sour beers, man. I had to slap a biohazard sticker on my asshole.
Well, or you can also have a parasite and you get pretty bad gas.
Goat Belly is wondering, what part of Texas? I'm going to be in West Texas, about an hour outside of Abilene, in a little town called Sweetwater.
Yeah, Goat Belly is Pat Wax Daddy.
I know, Pat Wax Daddy. Uh-huh. Goat Belly!
That's what I called him on the... I used to be able to do the whole roll call of platoon by nicknames.
Well, that's what you do. I used to be video dude for like the first 4 years you and I worked together.
Yeah.
And then one day you call me Blake and I'm like, squirrel? What? Shit.
I don't remember names, man.
I know.
I just don't. That groove is gone in my thinking meat.
Ascension is says, you know your farts are bad when people look at you in concern instead of disgust.
You're dying. Are you rotting from the inside out?
Maybe. James P. wants to know which hotel in Vegas. I honestly don't know. This is all part of Donovan Sharp's thing. We're going to be there for a promo shoot. So I will get in touch with him, and I will let everybody know in the next stream, which will be Tuesday.
Or we could put it up on our Facebook.
Could put it up on the Facebook, too. We have Facebook. We have Minds. We have MeWe. We have Parler. There is a Gab, even though I didn't make it. Actually, MG made it for us.
Fuck yeah.
But I still, I know, they deleted our damn account for no reason whatsoever.
And they didn't just delete our account. They denied us access to the site. I still can't get in there. Like, it's like, you don't have permission to see this. Like, what the fuck is that?
Shitballs, Chopper, shitballs.
I will slap that motherfucker in the
face. There's somebody in the chat named Blake who lives in Abilene. Winning. Hey, shoot an email to ridiculous12@gmail.com. I'm happy to meet up with anybody as long as you don't show up wanting to beat my ass.
How many people we have watching now?
We still have over 900 people watching. Thank you all for tuning in all the way to the bitter end. We love having you guys on the show.
Fuck
we love
yeah.
reading your chats. And, I'm glad that we're doing this twice a week now. It's good stuff. Shall you take us out with a safety briefing, good sir, since you did your cadence already?
Yeah. All right, gentlemen. Don't drink and swim. Don't drink and drive. Don't walk on thin ice. In fact, don't even walk on ice, because if you fall through, you're doubly fucked.
And if you call it black ice on YouTube, you get banned.
Yeah, you get a strike for that.
It's stunning and brave person of color ice.
If you have to fight, don't fight alone. And please don't go to the ground, because that's how people get stomped out.
True story.
All right.
All right. I will be broadcasting to you all the next time you see my silly ass, unless you actually follow us on Alt Tech. Then you're going to see me from the Ride and Roast. Tuesday night, Grunt Speak, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central, which is where I'll be. And, hey, maybe I'll bring some more of this cheap wine. Never know.
All right, man. Cool.
It's cool. We're going to be doing this kind of weird. So you're going to be calling in via Zoom. I'm going to be running the chat like normal. So my signal is going to look great. Yours is going to look like your shitty webcam.
Pretty much.
But at least it'll still be us.
Well, I'll try to hook up that high definition cam I have.
Yeah, I mean, you bought that, what, 10 years ago?
Four years ago.
Hook it up.
Yep.
Do it.
I know, I will.
Make it happen.
Okay.
Grunt. Yeah. All right, y'all have a good night.
Take it easy. Tight.
If you drank a menagerie, B vitamin, water, and in the morning, bananas. Not the kind that they give out on the gay cruise.
Wear a condom, because that's how kids come about.
Yes. And make sure that you flush it when you're done.
Yes.
Never, ever leave it in the trash, because that's how you get sperm jacked. Not that I would know or anything.
Oh, my God.
Exactly.
That'd be bad.
It would be very bad.